is a live presentation of CBC Sports. The waterfront's tranquility will soon be broken. Now, on most summer days, it's with the sounds of families at play at Ontario Place. And, of course, Toronto's downtown is always accessible, waiting to come alive. And there's the allure of the entertainment district. The top billing here this afternoon, Indy. Greg Moore is just 23, and the British Columbia native is making a serious run at Champ Car contention. Michael Andretti owns the C&E grounds. How about 5 victories in the last 9 races here? Never count him out. Is it time for Jimmy Vasser to finally win in Toronto? Why not, says the Californian who topped the kart series in 96. And there's no doubting who is number one. It's Alex Zanardi, 5 wins in 98, and the runaway points leader, looking to deliver a 3rd title in a row for Chip Ganassi. As we look live on this Sunday afternoon, we had bright sunshine early this morning. Clouds have moved into southern Ontario. So far, no rain. And as of right now, if the rain holds off, racing conditions are excellent. We will have a record crowd here this afternoon for the 1998 Molson Indy Toronto. With 3-time Indianapolis 500 champion, my regular partner, Bobby Unser. Good afternoon, everyone. Good morning to our Western viewers. I'm Brian Williams. Welcome to Toronto. Listen, Zanardi's won 3 in a row. All I hear up and down pit row this morning is Zanardi, Zanardi, Zanardi. Do we even need to stay here for the next couple hours? I mean, we can take off and go golfing or something.
Think we ought to go take off and do something? No. Let me tell you something. This is the most competitive series in motor racing in the world. And there's a lot of guys down there. Look at Frank Keady on the pole 2 times in a row last year and this year. Brian, he's going to be tough. And maybe he won't make any mistakes this year because everybody learns, especially if they're that good. Look at, for example, we never pick him. 5-time winner here, Michael Andretti. Michael, I always tell you in the race, he is super tough. If his car keeps going, he's got all the ingredients to win. And this series, because it's so competitive, it's probably got about 15 guys that you could just throw the names out and see how they come out.
All right, we are going to stay here for the next couple of hours. Michael Andretti drives for Paul Newman and Carl Haas. Paul Newman is making a movie in Montreal, flew in here this morning. One name I like possibly this afternoon is Gilles Deferrin. Bobby Unser will call the race today, working in the pits from ESPN. Greg Creamer and Jan Bikas. In fact, right now, let's go down to the pits. Jan Bikas standing by with a pole sitter, Scotland's Dario Franchitti.
Well, Dario, first of all, congratulations on pole position. But for you, it's the second time you've been on pole here, and I know you hope it's not a repeat of last year.
Yeah, last year was a bit of a disaster. You know, it was great getting my first pole here in Toronto, but the race really lasted as long as the first corner when I was hit from behind and put into a spin. So hopefully that's not going to happen this year.
So what can you do differently to make sure it doesn't happen?
I think start slightly better, do a better job at the start, and brake a little bit later in the first corner. Probably protect the inside. If somebody's coming down, don't even give them a look, because I think the problem last year was Bobby thought there was a 50-50 chance and there wasn't. So don't do that again.
Have you practiced it?
I practiced a little bit in that session, what I was going to do. But it's quite difficult with traffic out there. You know, you don't want to get in the way of a lot of people. But yeah, I practiced as much as I could.
All right, Dario Franchitti, the man who starts on pole. Brian?
When you told me he's like Jackie Stewart, I said, at least Stewart sounds Italian. Bobby says Franchitti sounds Italian until he begins speaking with that Scottish accent. Listen, Franchitti's got the pole this afternoon. Chip Ganassi with Vasser and Zanardi's dominated. Very quickly, what is so special about this Ganassi team?
Well, the thing is, it's one of those dream teams that got put together by accident. When Chip got Zanardi, he was just a guy that came from Europe that he thought he would be good, but the main thing is he was cheap. Believe what I'm telling you now, cheap. Cheap and yet a good driver, so he got Zanardi. And Vasser the same way. Vasser come up through the Atlantics, he was very good, but again, cheap. And at those days, it was just kind of going together. Well, now look, they've got the dream team put together and they're trying to keep it together, but it won't be cheap anymore.
It won't be cheap anymore. Zanardi wants $7 or $8 million to stay. Speaking of Team Ganassi, a closer look at Chip Ganassi Racing. Alex Zanardi and Jimmy Vasser have been piling up the numbers. 7 wins as a team. Winning percentage of 31 in Zanardi's kart career. 2 PPG titles back to back.
A lot of people have a lot of opinions why. I mean, I just look at the continuity within the team members. You know, we certainly have good partners in with us, whether it's our sponsors, whether it's our engine supplier, our tire suppliers. We have good partners that want to win races.
Just probably these guys, you know, behind us and all the people that we work with really closely with Honda and Firestone and Reynard. And again, just the personnel. It's a people business and it's a team sport.
According to Vasser, the 96 car champion, the team's success emanates right from the top, the boss.
Somebody's got to make the big decisions, and you know, it's got to be Chip Ganassi. His name's on the side of the truck, so he's made some good ones, and he's writing the big checks as well.
Well, I don't know. I think anybody that has a modicum of racing experience, I mean, sort of figured one day Honda would get it right, you know, in terms of engines.
Add to the technical components a pair of top-flight drivers who know the value of teamwork. That's made the difference for the Chip Ganassi team.
A lot of things collided right on the right point at the right time for me, like, you know, having the Honda engines, the Firestone tires, the Reynard chassis. Such a great organization like the Target Chip Ganassi Racing working behind me.
While Jimmy and Alex both understand that they're in a race with each other, it's rarely, if ever, come down to the two of them, and they help each other along throughout the whole weekend.
I think it rubs off on the whole team and everybody. You know, it provides a good atmosphere. Everybody's having fun still and getting along. And so, you know, it's just good chemistry.
Jimmy Vasser is a fantastic person off the car and into the car, and it's very easy to get along well with him. So he truly became a friend of mine. And despite the fact we are teammates and despite the fact that there is a lot of competition between the two of us,
what I think my guys do, they do the obvious things very well, okay? They make very few mistakes. We've racked up a lot of points over the years watching our competition just make mistakes trying to catch us.
Coveted by Formula One, Zanardi with 13 wins in the last 2.5 seasons may be coy about revealing his future plans, but he is firm in his commitment to Chip Ganassi.
A lot of people believe that because I'm European, I'm certainly going to go to Formula One. That's not written anywhere. You know, I had a fantastic time with this team. I can tell you, the only thing I can tell you right now is that if I decide to remain in the United States, there is a chance as high as probably 99% that I will remain with Target Chip Ganassi Racing, because this team has been able to provide me a lot of goods, a lot of success. I'm being good to this team, but this team has been good for me, so I'm gonna try not to break this winning combination.
Word we hear, it's all but a done deal, Zanardi to F1. Up next, the troubled Canadians, in particular Paul Tracy. Bobby will have a lot more to say about Tracy during the race. Up next, Tracy and Moore under a cloud.
In other countries, differences of opinion may cause persecution, imprisonment, or even war.
It's Canada-wide clearance time, featuring 1.9% financing and excellent leases on a huge selection of most 98 models, like the sporty, fun-to-drive Pontiac Sunfire Coupe. The Pontiac Grand Prix with wide track for outstanding handling and control. The Century by Buick. Surround yourself with a surprising touch of luxury. Hurry in for Canada-wide clearance at your Pontiac, Buick, GMC dealers.
The coolest game on earth now offers the coolest credit card on earth. It's the official no-annual-fee NHL MasterCard issued by NBNA Canada. Call toll-free 1-877-HOCKEY-9 and apply for the credit card featuring your favorite NHL team logo. Score with exclusive cardholder benefits and save with a low introductory annual interest rate. A credit card made for hockey fans like you. The official no-annual-fee NHL MasterCard. Call toll-free 1-877-HOCKEY-9 now to apply for your official National Hockey League MasterCard.
The Beaver, A diligent handyman spends hours searching for home renovation materials. Unfortunately, though, he often forgets what he's looking for. A ClearNet PCS phone and its affordable rate plans would enable him to call home whenever he needs a reminder. But like many a handyman, he doesn't take criticism well.
No contract to sign and very affordable to use. Isn't it time you had a ClearNet PCS phone?
The Molson Indy, live on CBC. Brought to you by Export Ale, title sponsor of the Molson Indy. By Chevrolet. Chevrolet, tried, tested, and true. And by MBNA Canada, a proud sponsor of the Molson Indy.
And on this now cloudy Sunday afternoon, we're back live in Toronto as we count it down to the start of the 1998 Molson Indy Toronto. You know, when the Canadian drivers come either to Toronto or Montreal, they normally get a boost in confidence. It could be a different story, though. They're not coming confident, at least two of them. I'm talking about Paul Tracy and Greg Moore. Both Moore and Tracy come here on probation. Now, they've both tasted victory, but lately they've been racing to endanger. There's no question these two Canadians have been a cloud.
Paul Tracy is playing the bad boy once again. When he came up behind Christian Fittipaldi and tapped him out of the way on Belle Isle in the Detroit Grand Prix, he was promptly placed on probation. Then, in Cleveland, he and Al Unser Jr. couldn't find enough room to share the track. Tracy would only share the blame.
You know, having talked to Al after the race, we were both going for it. We were both running more competitively than we have in a long time, and I think it was pretty much a 50-50 deal. And, you know, it was just one of those situations where we're both racing out of the pits and got together, you know, and yellow flag pit stop when everybody's pitted at the same time. It's just one of those situations.
I've watched Paul over the years, and I've seen him win races and make a few mistakes here or there. So we knew we were getting a guy that very aggressive style and a guy prone to making a few mistakes. But he's brought a lot to this team, and we're very, very pleased with Paul Tracy.
While the owner endorses Tracy's driving, the driver can only set his sights on his immediate future.
Well, I think it's been very frustrating. I think we've had a lot of bad luck, and we've had some bad calls go our way, and, you know, I've made some mistakes as well. So, you know, we got to put it past us. We're here in Toronto. This is the most important race of the year for me. Our focus is on this race, not last weekend or the week before or the week before that. So we've got a job to do here, and that's try to win the Molson Indy.
Rio winner Greg Moore's signals have been crossed of late. His spin at Cleveland was deemed a racing incident without further implications on his probation. That status was earned in Portland when he tried to force the issue too fast, too soon. Moore openly admits his mistake.
Well, I mean, I saw a hole there, and I went through there slower than I'd gone pretty much all weekend in the first place, and it was just because everyone else had just been backed up, I just misjudged how slow everyone would be going.
The concern for Moore and his players' Forsyth team is more an issue of all drivers operating under the same rules and standards.
As long as it's consistent, you know, as long as here at Toronto someone goes, you know, flying in turn one and knocks two or three guys out of the race, as long as they go on probation, as long as it's nice and consistent that way, the rules are fair, it's no problem.
Greg Moore and Paul Tracy come together in Toronto, hoping to get out from under the cloud and back into the glow of winner's circle.
All right, Bobby Unser, are Moore and Tracy being treated fairly?
They are being treated fairly, I promise you, in fact, too fairly. Tracy has got to quit wrecking. He's got to quit being so reckless. He's got to quit making excuses. He's got to grow up. He needs to become what I call a race driver. Moore, on the other hand, hey, he's really doing good. Zanardi's getting to him. The pressure's on too much. Moore is gold. He's going to be good. Just needs to slow down a little bit and he'll be fine, Brian.
That's what I like about Unser. He never has an opinion, folks. Stay with us. Up next, it is the final go-round for a living legend. A good friend of Bobby Unser's, Bobby Rahal, is up next.
All across Canada, we're making it easier to get out on the road during Canada-wide clearance. Right now, get outstanding lease offers or 1.9% financing on virtually every vehicle, including the car more Canadians depend on, the Chevrolet Cavalier. And on the Chevrolet Malibu, you'll get a lot more than you expect. Or drive home in the sophisticated midsize Oldsmobile Intrigue. The huge selection makes this a great time to buy or lease. So hit the road to your Chevrolet Oldsmobile dealer for Canada-wide clearance.
Hey, just finished staining the gazebo.
Great, what'd you use, redwood or cedar?
Well,
at Home Hardware, there's no need to limit yourself.
So this stain comes in lots of colors.
How many?
Woodshield Exterior Stain from Home Hardware comes in more than 1,000 colors. All backed by our no-quibble guarantee.
1,000? How did you decide?
Well,
Home Hardware.
Cool, what about the fence?
Help is close to home.
Mondays on CBC. Tune in at 7 and laugh all night long.
No, 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 I'm all right. I just need a little tofu.
Kind of chick magnet, huh?
Most powerful man in Canada. Hands of a girl.
Nuns! Nuns! Reverse! Reverse!
I am not afraid to put my foot down. It is okay, it was only an Anglo.
Comedy Mondays continue all summer long on CBC.
You were with her for 6 months.
Yeah, well, that's a long time, you know? I mean, you know, the mystery was over, man.
What did she do? As I'm positive, it's her fault completely.
You know, she started talking about getting married.
Jesus, and what did you say?
I asked her, you know, who she was planning on marrying and if, you know, she'd be kind enough to invite me to the wedding.
You said that to her?
And still to come, Bobby Unser with a special computer-animated tour of this temporary street circuit in Toronto as we look at the start-finish line. You know, from his days in Can-Am racing 25 years ago to his victory in the first-ever Molson Indy in 1986, there's no question. Bobby Rahal has loved racing here in Canada. The other night he was telling me about racing against the late Gilles Villeneuve in the old Formula Atlantic days. It's the final go-round for the veteran Rahal, but make no mistake about it. He is as competitive as ever.
He takes the checkered flag at Bobby Rahal, as you see the celebrations of the fence, as he has won here in the $800,000 Molson Indy.
The race was just one of those races where everything worked out well, even with the stop and go. Or actually, it was a stop and wait, you know. They said I passed the pace car, and they stopped me and made us wait till the whole field caught up. It was the thing, really, that got us going to win the championship, because after that was our second win of the year, including Indy, but we won four more times that year. And it was really from this race on, we pretty much dominated the rest of the year.
1986 was a watershed season for Rahal, winning the Indy 500 and clinching his first of three championships with a true sports team. Yet, for the soft-spoken Ohioan, success was hardly anticipated.
And I didn't even expect to race, let alone professionally, let alone have the success we had. So it's all been, as I've said to people, there was a dream, you know, you always thought, wouldn't it be great, but it just seemed so far-fetched that it didn't seem a possibility. And just over the years, things progressed and, you know, one thing led to another, and we were able to achieve not only the dream, but really, I think, exceed whatever expectations we had.
At age 45, after 24 kart victories, Bobby's saying his final goodbyes as a driver. Now he'll concentrate on his ownership role and with an increased awareness.
And I think being a driver gives a perspective that a lot of owners don't have, because they've never done it. And I think that's what's always made Roger Penske so successful, or Jim Hall, or any of the guys that actually drove race cars that then became owners, is I think your perspective of issues is a broader one. And you understand how it affects things beyond just either the bottom line or a crew or what have you, how it affects a driver's psyche, and I think that's important.
Each track he visits on his final ride brings back memories and stirs emotions. But Rahal is determined to go out just as he entered, with businesslike determination.
You know, as much as everybody's kind of focusing on the fact that it's my last one and is there going to be an emotional reaction to it, frankly, my biggest challenge this year, and the thing that I really wanted to make sure of, was that I was going to be competitive and that I was going to try to win a race. So when I come to these tracks, you know, I'm just thinking about how are we going to win this race or be very competitive. So, you know, it's all business as the weekend starts, and then certainly as the weekend goes on, and particularly after the race, you look back over your shoulder and think about the great days you had.
With Bobby's departure, that is going to leave at the end of the season arguably one of the more popular and certainly sought-after rides open, the Miller Lite Ride. Now, who's going to fill it? Well, if Bobby knows, he's keeping it close to his chest. He hasn't announced it, but he has made it very clear. Whoever it is will be able to win right off. Ryan?
Greg, one name I hear being mentioned, Heinz Harald Frentzen from Formula One. Up next, Bobby Unser takes us around this track with computer animation.
As Canada's auto parts store, Canadian Tire offers you even more. Like our Loan-A-Tool program. If you need an auto tool, just come to our auto parts counter, choose from a selection of specialized tools, and we'll loan you one at no charge. And there's more. You can also bring your brake drums and rotors to any Canadian Tire auto parts counter, and one of our staff will expertly machine them for you. It's convenient, and you know the job will be done right. Canadian Tire, Canada's auto parts store.
It's a constant battle. Technology striving for the perfect automobile finish. Nature dead set on destroying it. But Turtle Wax fights back with an army of advanced auto care. For quick, easy shine in minutes, Express Shine. To condition tires, dash, and leather. Formula 2001 Super Protectant. For a brilliant finish, Emerald Series Car Wax. Even weathered veterans come out shining with Turtle Wax at the front.
I have long-distance news. Sprint Canada has changed forever the way you use long-distance. Unlimited calling in Canada.
Call to anywhere in Canada and talk all you want evenings and weekends for just $20 a month. Call Sprint Canada at 1-800-THE-MOST today.
You could say this is revolutionary.
Canadians
are afraid of the
detail
between Iraq and
the world.
Sunday Report, tonight on CBC.
Hackers are about anarchism.
They're young, they're smart, and they're being locked up without bail or trial.
The punishment should fit the crime.
Are they terrorists or victims of hacker hysteria? Undercurrents with Wendy Mesley, tonight at 10:30.
And the view from the Hilfiger airship on this Sunday afternoon, the command to start engines in just a couple of minutes. Bobby Unser, Peter Graham, and his company SGS from Ottawa with that great computer animation. About 12 people, they put it together of this course. Let's run it now as we did yesterday and take us around this temporary street circuit here in Toronto.
Now, there is a pretty course right there. That's what it looks like from the air. Here we are in our computer car. Watch this. Isn't that something? That's a heck of a job. Look at all the people in the grandstand. This car is coming down right now into the start-finish line, roughly where we are. Right there went by. Now we're going into the first turn. 90 degree, there's the cement. The white represents cement patches on the track. Another right-hand turn. This really starts a long straightaway, like 190 miles an hour. Look on the right. There's the gears that they're in. There's the time going around the track. Now, this is the place where we have most of our passing going on. 160-degree turn to the right across the cement. They outbreak each other and pass going into the turn. Now we're going to a 90-degree to the left, another big cement patch. Greg Moore's right and griping about that. You come around to the right here, starts what we call the back straightaway. Also some passing right at the end of this. Right down here, they'll break hard again. We'll see cars pass there. Another cement patch. Round to the left here, very fast, very wide. Not much passing going to happen down here. This is all really fast stuff, kind of in front where we are here. Round, round, very, very fast, very dangerous. And there's the start-finish line.
And we're just about ready for the official ceremonies. The master of ceremonies is the popular morning man from CFRB Radio in Toronto. There he is, Ted Wallachin. Ted?
Thank you so much, and ladies and gentlemen, once again, good afternoon, and welcome to the 13th running of the Molson Indy here through the streets of Toronto. It's been an exciting week with a number of festivities that have taken place. We, of course, are all anxious for this, the 13th running, and the final appearance of Bobby Rahal. We're going to take a couple of moments now to introduce you to some folks who are key to the success of this wonderful event. First of all, would you please welcome from Molson Breweries, Mr. Dave Perkins, the president of the Ontario and Atlantic regions.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome on behalf of Molson to the 1998 Molson Indy Toronto. It's great to have you all back for another exciting event. Race fans across the country are tuned to CBC and RDS to watch the excitement and to feel the pride as our Canadian drivers compete so successfully on the world stage. Best wishes to Greg Moore, Patrick Carpentier, and Paul Tracy, who have developed a loyal following across Canada and throughout North America. Another crowd favorite and a great friend of Molson who I'd like to acknowledge is Bobby Rahal, who won our first race here in 1986. Bobby hasn't missed a race in Toronto since, and he's provided us with many great memories over the years. Thanks, Bobby, and on behalf of all your fans, good luck today in this, your final run in Toronto. And to the other drivers from the United States and around the world, all the best for a safe and successful race. Molson is proud to support auto racing in Canada, and we thank you, the fans, for being here with us. It obviously couldn't happen without you. And our thanks also go to the many volunteers who make this weekend so successful, and to the residents and businesses of Toronto who have helped the Molson Indy Festival Foundation raise $1.5 million for children's charities. Please enjoy the race, and we look forward to seeing you all again for the Molson Indy Vancouver on the Labor Day weekend. Cheers and take care.
Thank you very much, Dave. Ladies and gentlemen, we have three special guests who are about to join us here on the victory podium. Not only are we celebrating the 13th anniversary of the Molson Indy, but also the 2 millionth race fan walked through the doors today, and in conjunction with our friends at the Toronto Sun, we will welcome him on stage, and he, in fact, will assist us with the magic words. Ladies and gentlemen, John Spadaro. Welcome him, John. Good to see you, John. Again, congratulations for winning the Toronto Sun contest. Next, ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome from the province of Ontario, the Minister of Tourism, the Honorable Al Palladini. And now, ladies and gentlemen, a special guest from the province of Alberta, the city of Calgary. He's part owner of the junior franchise in the WHL. Welcome from the World Championship Wrestling, Brett the Hit Hartman. Here we go.
I know it's Brett the Hitman Hart, but I get a little nervous. The guy's bigger than me.
Gentlemen, we're going to count this down from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Gentlemen, start your engines!
To start the engines, car 27 is the pole sitter from Edinburgh, Scotland, Dario Franchitti. Talked about Jackie Stewart earlier, Bobby. I think I said Jackie sounds Italian. Jackie, of course, sounds Scottish, but Stewart has been telling me about young Franchitti for years, back when we worked the Canadian Grand Prix in Montreal. Stewart's been a great fan over the years of young Dario Franchitti, and as we talked last night, you were still saying to me that Franchitti, if Zanardi goes to Formula One, Franchitti is the next major star in IndyCar racing.
I really think the guy is multi-talented. You know, it just takes a little bit of experience for him to get all this down pat. In other words, crashing the first turn won't work. But to see a guy that's so classy in a car that can get around any racetrack as fast as he does, put a little bit of experience with it, and you're going to see another one like Mr. Zanardi.
What will happen now? The cars, there's the defending champion, Mark Lindell. The cars will go out and they will go by twice, two laps, third time by it will be the green flag, and they should be racing. That is, if they're lined up properly, they come out, they'll go around once, go around twice, and the third time by, they should be racing.
And they will be. These guys are good. Remember, this is the finest in the world. You don't find better race drivers than this. You don't see better racing, and you don't see more competition. If these guys can't line up for a start, there's something wrong. Now, when they go into the first turn, I hope nobody's at home going to get a beer right then, because that's the one to watch going into the first turn. That's when Franchitti had his problem last year. That's when we don't want any problems, because we want a good race.
Well, the first of three warm-up laps just underway here in the Toronto waterfront this afternoon. It's a 28-car field. And while we have a chance, let's run down the grid for this 98 Molson Indy Toronto. The pole sitter, as I mentioned, is Dario Franchitti from Scotland, alongside Alex Zanardi. He's won three in a row, won a week ago today in Cleveland. And we move on to row number two. Bobby talked about Michael Andretti. He's won five times here. Bobby, I don't know about you, but I like Gilles Deferrin's chances here this afternoon driving for Derek Walker.
One of these days, his luck is going to change, and then watch out for Deferrin.
Christian Fittipaldi driving for Paul Newman and Carl Haas. There's Zanardi's teammate, the 96 PPG champion, Jimmy Vasser. On to row number four, good young driver out of the Indy Lights Series, Tony Kanaan.
Really and surprised everybody this year. He's going good.
Yeah, he is going very, very good and very well. And Scott Pruitt, the veteran American driver, has had his problems of late. Speaking of veterans, there's Bobby Rahal, one here in 86. Paul Tracy, you heard Bobby Unser say it, has to get his act together. On to row number six, Andre Ribeiro, who drives for Roger Penske. There's Greg Moore. Moore starting 12th fastest after practice yesterday. Richie Hearn from California. Al Unser Jr., what do you have yesterday? Transmission problem?
Transmission. Both he and Ribeiro. Transmission problems one after the other. That takes away all their practice time. Too many problems.
Mark Lundell for PacWest. And PacWest has been an interesting story here this year. They're having all kinds of problems. He's the defending champion. Adrian Fernandez won here a couple of years ago. On to row number nine, Brian Herta had that terrible accident. Remember, past the start-finish line in practice driving for A.J. Boyd
terrible
a couple years ago, broke
did.
His leg. There's Patrick Carpentier. You like Carpentier from Joliet, Quebec.
I think he's going to be a good driver in the future. I really do.
Maurizio Gugelman is Blundell's teammate at PacWest. There's Mad Max Pappas, as he's known here on the IndyCar circuit. Another rookie, Helio Castroneves, drove very well last year.
Another guy out of the Indy Lights series, Brian.
That's exactly where he came from, Indy Lights. Robbie Gordon comes from NASCAR. Former kart driver, went to NASCAR. There's a great name. You knew Parnelli well. His son, PJ Jones. Michelle Jourdain Jr., a racing family out of Mexico City. Arnd Meyer from Germany. JJ Leto from Finland, a former Formula One driver. 28 cars race here this afternoon, the 14th and final row. Alex Baron drove well in the Formula Atlantic. In fact, he won it as a rookie in 1997. And Gülter Salas had an unfortunate accident. He wasn't hurt yesterday in practice. We're on board with Michael Andretti. They're on the second of three warm-up laps.
And Salas' problem, incidentally, that was a stuck throttle. Throttle stuck wide open on that car. Remember yesterday you said, I wonder if he had a mechanical problem? That's real mechanical problem.
Bobby, as we look at Michael Andretti, you see some moisture on the visor. These are tearaway visors.
Right, it's not moisture
looks like
at all.
Moisture.
It looks like it because that's the plastic touching together with no air in between. So at the other places that don't look like they're touching is air. They just tear those off as they get dirty. The cars up front show off their oil or dirt off the track. And the guy just reaches up, tears them off.
On board with Alex Zanardi as he follows the pole sitter around, the pole sitter being Dario Franchitti. They are now coming by for the second time. The next time by, they should go racing, and we understand Jan Vikas has a report from the pits. Jan?
Yes, and it does relate to Alex Zanardi. Alex Zanardi had a turbocharger problem this morning in the warm-up. The exhaust fan broke on the turbocharger. It got sucked into the engine and blew the engine up. So Alex Zanardi had to make a quick engine change. The crew is confident that everything was done right on the car, but remember, this is an unproven engine for Zanardi.
Thank you, Jan. Bobby, tires are a big story, and for those people that don't watch a lot of motor racing, what they're simply doing, going side to side, you see Franchitti is warming up those tires.
Yeah, no, the idea is to get the rubber all working a little bit, because when it sits still, it doesn't work, and it's a little harder. And it also gets the sidewalls of the tires all flexible. kind of like your muscles. When you wake up in the morning, you stretch real good. That's what they're doing to the tires right now.
Dario Franchitti, and remember, you were with us for the pre-race show. He talked about the first corner last year. Bobby Rahal got a little inside of him and bumped him, and although he came back to race, for all intents and purposes, his day was through. Now you're on board with Bobby Rahal, who won here in 1986.
You know, the thing about the start, people must realize, is it's very hard to pass on a road circuit track like this, but if you can pass guys going into the first turn, it's almost like it's free, Brian. So that's the reason we always see problems going into turn one.
And again, for people that don't watch a lot of racing, explain why they pass into the corners instead of on the straight.
That's where they brake. And if you can outbrake a guy, get your braking better and get your depth perception. Like we used to talk about Little Al, he has depth perception that is beyond belief. He can look at a turn and brake even all the way into the turn and barely make the turn at the apex of it.
Third time by. If they're lined up properly, there's the pace car off to the left. We should be racing. The pole sitter, Franchitti, is on the left. On the right is Alex Zanardi. Down into the start-finish area.
Lined up really good.
The green flag, and they're racing in Toronto. Into the first corner, unlike last year, and through cleanly is the pole sitter, Dario Franchitti. Down onto Lakeshore Boulevard. Fastest part of this race course comes the 28 car field, and Bobby, you predicted it, no problems with the start into that first quarter this year.
Now though, we're going right down into where everybody doesn't pass it. Here is a big problem area. Let's watch now, see if the guys get through here with no problem. Two abreast, fantastic. Look at them all, a lot of two abreast going in there. So far, no problem. Now that's got to be a record.
Michael Andretti, followed by Gilles DeFerrin, running third and fourth, respectively. The leader is Dario Franchitti with Zanardi right on his tail.
Remember, the first lap will be the slowest lap of the race, so that's the time that it's easier to pass. That's the reason often they have wrecks or a little bit of touching the first lap around.
Bobby, take us around as we'll hold this shot. We're on board now with Zanardi.
Right
down into turn one.
Into the first turn right here where they normally have a lot of problems. There's a cement. Remember, that's very slippery. As you read in the paper, Greg Moore says it's bad. They need to asphalt them. I agree with it. This is a long straightaway. Zanardi is not keeping up with Franchitti right now. But it's too early to make a big issue out of it. They need to get the cars kind of going and see how everybody's going to act. He was too wide on that one. That's very rare for Zanardi to be that wide. Round to the left here. Looks like he's pulling up on Franchitti, but as the straightaways come around, Franchitti moves right away. Round a right-hand turn. Now this, in a lot of ways, starts the back straightaway. Even though it's a right-hand turn there, here's where they break hard. You'll see some passing as the day goes on right there. Around to the left here, very fast turn, very wide. Round to the right, very wide again. No passing here hardly, it's too fast. Now we're going across the start-finish line right where we are here.
We talked so much as we look at Michael Andretti, who's now running third. There's Zanardi, followed by Andretti. Gilles DeFerrin, Jimmy Vasser has moved to fifth. Paul Tracy has made a move up to sixth place. We talk about tires and chassis. Let's not forget the engines. The first two cars, Franchitti and Zanardi, are both Honda powered.
Yes, and you know, today, though, we've got a Mercedes, we got Toyota, we got Honda, and Ford. Whoa, look at that. I had to hold my breath right there.
That's Paul Tracy. Paul Tracy just ahead of Christian Fittipaldi. There's Paul Tracy, followed by Christian Fittipaldi, Scott Pruitt, and Canaan, the rookie. Tracy driving very well so far here this afternoon.
Canaan almost got put out into the wall on that, but he got very close getting clipped. There's Tracy in the green and white car. Cool car.
Paul Tracy needs a big race here in Toronto. One here in 1993. You said it earlier, Bobby. He's got to quit making excuses, quit wrecking cars, and start racing.
No, he's a good race driver. He's very fast. Well, I shouldn't say he's a good race driver. He's very fast. If he quits having all these wrecks, he'll be a good race driver.
And Bobby, what the crew is telling him on the radio, be careful with your tires. Team Cool Green is concerned. They're trying to warn Paul Tracy not to drive the car too fast too soon.
And John, as you've just said that, we watched him come out of a corner. He had both rear tires just lit off and spinning sideways. So I agree with you. They need to tell him to just cool it. It's a long race here. Many turns to go.
On board with Christian Fittipaldi. Fittipaldi is running seventh, chasing the green car in front of him. That is Paul Tracy in sixth place. Early on in this 98-lap Toronto race, it's still Dario Franchitti leading Zanardi, and Andretti, DeBaron, Vasser, and Paul Tracy now sixth.
And everybody should keep in mind, Brian, that the pit stops are going to come around 25 to 30 laps, providing we don't have any yellow flags, which we hope we don't. We want to see good racing, but when we start watching the pit stop, we'll watch for pit strategy. That'll kind of tell us how the race is going to flow as we go along.
Great shot from the Hill Figure airship at the end of Lakeshore Boulevard, the right-hand turn. There's Franchitti, followed by Zanardi and Reddy. DeFerrin's a blue car. The other red car is Vasser. There's Paul Tracy, followed by Fittipaldi, Pruitt, Canaan, and Richie Hearn, rounding out the top 10.
And also keep in mind that Franchitti, who's leading the race right now, and Paul Tracy, at the same team. Puts a little bit of pressure on Paul. He knows his teammate is up leading the race. Been having no problems all weekend. Makes Paul try a little bit extra hard. That's one of the things he needs to settle down with and just realize Franchitti is one good race driver.
And it was last year that Franchitti got off to the rough start. There are the two players' cars. Craig Moore running 15th. He's the first player's car. The second car is Patrick Carpentier from Joliet, Quebec,
and look
running
at the red
in 16th
dot on,
place.
On Patrick's car, you can see the red dot on the nose when the camera's on a little bit better for the folks at home there.
You notice the red dot? There it is. And right behind them in the Takati car, the green and red machine, is Mexico's Adrian Fernandez, who won here in 1996.
And the all, look at there. That's all the bright colors. Look there. The green, the red. That's their Mexican from Mexico right there. Fernandez, he's really been having a good year too.
Patrick Carpentier trying to go
oh.
wide. That's Blundell, the defending champion, behind Fernandez.
You can see they're trying to pass any place they can map. Remember, Brian, that what happens is that their tires are good right now. They can pass now. But if they get near to a pit stop, the tires get worn out. They can't pass near as easy. So most of the attempts need to happen now.
Bobby, easier to pass on a full tank of fuel or an empty tank, or doesn't it matter?
Full tank. You get more traction. The car doesn't go as fast, but you get more grip. The tires are newer when you have a fuel tank. Everything's better for passing them.
So and Bobby, talking about fuel, Alex Zanardi, his crew has just told him to turn his fuel to position one. And this is known as one of the racetracks where you use a lot of extra fuel. So the crews are now telling their drivers, we need to save fuel now so we'll have fuel for the end of the race.
And Jan, interestingly, a development for Franchitti as well as Tracy, with Tracy's progress so far, just checked in with Barry Green and said, have you put some of Franchitti's setup on Paul's car? He said, actually, we took a little bit of Paul's setup and put it on Dario's car. It was so good this morning, they've massaged both cars a little bit, taking the best of each setup. That's why they're both looking very strong right now.
Great team Green doing very well here this afternoon as Paul Tracy is running sixth. And Dario Franchitti, of course, the pole sitter, continues to lead this race.
Even though Franchitti's on the pole, they never quit trying to make the cars better. And what they learned from the teams being together is what works on one car, they just put on the other one. You know, in the old days, we had secrets between the drivers. Today, it's all open and above board. What one driver gets, the other driver can't have if he wants it.
Well, a clean start and no yellow flags yet. We'll take a commercial break. You're watching live coverage of the 1998 Molson Indy from Toronto.
It's Canada-wide clearance time. Featuring 1.9% financing and excellent leases on a huge selection of most 98 models. Like the GMC Sierra, strength and style, 365 days a year. And the more than a minivan, GMC Safari. The GMC Jimny with capability and comfort. And the Pontiac Transport, the minivan that's built for drivers. Hurry in for Canada-wide clearance at your Pontiac Buick GMC dealers.
The coolest game on earth now offers the coolest credit card on earth. It's the official no-annual-fee NHL MasterCard issued by NBNA Canada. Call toll-free 1-877-HOCKEY-9 and apply for the credit card featuring your favorite NHL team logo. Score with exclusive cardholder benefits and save with a low introductory annual interest rate. A credit card made for hockey fans like you. The official no-annual-fee NHL MasterCard. Call toll-free 1-877-HOCKEY-9 now to apply for your official National Hockey League MasterCard.
Race fans, get ready for 3 days of fast-paced, high-stakes action on the water as the Ontario Place Offshore Challenge takes to the shores of Lake Ontario, September 11th to 13th. For more information, call 416-314-9835. Tickets available through Ticketmaster by calling 416-870-8000.
Back live in Toronto, the shots from the Hilfiger airship. It is still Dario Franchitti leading Alex Zanardi, Michael Andretti, Gilles DeFerrin, and Jimmy Vasser rounding out the top five. Paul Tracy with a great start to this race as we move over and look at Lakeshore Boulevard is running sixth. He is the top Canadian. The other two Canadians, Greg Moore is 15th and Patrick Carpentier is 16th.
Now I noticed as they were running around a little while ago while we were on break, Brian, that the two Marlboro cars, Ribeiro and Little Al, were running right one and two with Ribeiro just ahead of him. And interestingly enough, the cars looked like they were totally identical in speed.
There's the race leader, the white car on the right. That is Franchitti. Red car on the left is Zanardi. Down through the start-finish area. In front of this record crowd, now here's turn one. It'll be down across the cement, which is extremely slippery, and then on to Lakeshore Boulevard.
Now, it's interesting that Franchitti is quite a ways ahead. Look at the gap right there. Now, is he using his car too hard? That's what Garrett Key and Barry Green is wondering about and thinking. And right there, Alex Zanardi, that's one guy behind you you really hate to have behind you, because you don't know what he's thinking or what he's going to do.
And Bobby, what Barry
There's
Green
also been a bit of a development with Andretti, of course, a former five-time winner here. They're in a situation where they, too, have instructed Michael to back off a little bit. They need to conserve the tires. Remember, they're the third-place car. They're the first on Goodyears at this point. A little concerned about that. They also have backed off that fuel just a notch, trying to be a little bit careful early on.
You can see Franchitti and Zanardi right there. Right there's Franchitti, leading car. Zanardi in the red car right behind him. Now, they still keep staying about the same.
There's Michael Andretti, who's running third. Gilles DeFerrin is fourth.
That's
on
three
board now,
guys.
On board with Michael Andretti as he goes down Lakeshore Boulevard in third place. And you see the second place car of Zanardi is right out of sight.
Remember what we said about Michael, though, Brian. He is absolutely like a bulldog. I don't care how much he's jerking the steering wheel. I don't care how much the car jerks around. Michael will be tough. If his car doesn't break, the other guys better worry about him a bunch, because he could win this race. Five times he's already won it.
Michael Andretti won this year at Miami. He's had trouble since. Paul Newman is here today, along with his co-owner, Carl Haas. A five-time winner in Toronto. Andretti's content, too. We talk about race strategy. You wondered if maybe Franchitti was going out too quickly. Michael's content to sit back and let it develop.
Well, you know, it's too early. We don't even have a pit stop by us yet. It's too early for these guys to be taking any risk. Really hard on the cars. You think it's chipped all the way around this thing. Hard on brakes. They've got to be a little bit sensible in what they do early on.
And Bobby, what they are telling Michael on the radio is that they do not want him to be aggressive. They say you're running the same time as the leader. We need you to save fuel right now. So I'm sure Michael wants to get racy, but he knows if he wants to have fuel at the end, he has to save it now.
That Visteon car's Pruitt, followed by Richie Hearn, and there's Bobby Rahal. They are running.
There's the two Marlboro cars.
Ninth, 10th and 11th. Pruitt, Hearn, and Rahal, the two Marlboro cars, of course, are Ribeiro and Allenser Jr.
Those cars have just been there for a long time. Nobody's been doing much passing. Everything's been kind of status quo. Truant seems to be kind of, I was going to say holding the DLF. He isn't holding it up. He's going very fast. But he's kind of the front of that little dog pack right there.
Truant has been under some pressure to start performing. Scott Truant followed by Richie Hearn, Bobby Rahal, Andre Ribeiro, and Al Unser Jr. We talked about those Penske cars. Penske is stuck at 99 victories, still looking for number 100. There come the two Penske cars, the orange and white Marlboro cars.
It's going to be interesting on what Roger Penske is going to decide for next year. We think that Ribeiro is going to be leaving that team. Now, who he's going to get, I don't know. That's the two Penske cars, the red and white ones there, as you said. There's Scott Pruitt is leading that pack right there. Now, Scott Pruitt, we hear, is going to be losing his ride also. So he's going to be looking around for something else to drive. That's Pat Patrick's car, Mission car there.
Bobby, you talk about a possible vacancy. Matt Penske, you were saying yesterday, Greg Moore could end up with Roger Penske in 1999.
Well, do we know that? I don't. I think we're guessing. But I think that's what Roger would like. Greg Moore is one fine race driver. Like we said earlier, if he'll just settle down a little bit, quit worrying about Zanardi, he's double quick.
On board with Bobby Rahal, currently running 11th, you're watching live coverage of the Molson Indy Toronto on CBC.
As Canada's auto parts store, Canadian Tire offers you even more. Like our Loan-A-Tool program. If you need an auto tool, just come to our auto parts counter, choose from a selection of specialized tools, and we'll loan you one at no charge. And it doesn't end there. Because right now, you can bring in your battery, alternator, or starter to any Canadian Tire auto parts counter, and we'll give it a free electrical test to ensure everything is in working order. Canadian Tire, Canada's auto parts store.
Somewhere out there, there is a chair with your name on it. Executive First. More personal space than any other business class from Canada. Hey, I like this chair.
Back live in Toronto, that is Richie Hearn as he spins and he's back in this race. Richie Hearn is in 10th place. Just ahead of Bobby Rahal, Andre Ribeiro, and Al Unser Jr. The race leader is still Dario Franchitti, followed by Zanardi, Andretti, DeFerrin, Vasser, Paul Tracy, still sixth. Seventh is Fittipaldi, Canaan is eighth, Pruitt is ninth, and we saw Bobby Rahal in 10th place. This great shot from the Hilfiger airship as they come up underneath the Gardiner Expressway, the lake to the right. There's the race leader, Dario Franchitti, now with a considerable lead over Alex Zanardi. Now, Bobby, we are going to go down to Greg Creamer in just a minute and talk about tires. And one thing that you pointed out during the commercial break we should be looking for is the pilling, if you will, the little bits of rubber on the sides of the track.
What it is, it's that we'll see it in a minute, and I'll point it out, but everybody get ready to see it. If you see the cameras go around, you folks at home watch, you'll see those little balls. You see on the left, you see on the right there, those are little balls of rubber right there. Now those things make this track extremely slippy. And as the race goes on after the second pit stop, we'll see too many of these, which prevents the cars from being able to pass the other cars, right?
Franchitti's lead, just over 3 seconds over Alex Zanardi. Greg Creamer, tires are so very, very important. You have an interesting explanation down in the pits.
Well, tires are absolutely crucial, and there's a lot to a tire. The compound, hard or soft, the construction of the tire, how it works, that all generates grip. Well, this is a set, it's a full set of pre-scuffed tires, and what's so crucial about making all of those different elements come together, it has to be almost like magic to work. This is a rear tire for a current Champ car. It's big, it's impressive, but the key is, at speeds of over 200 miles an hour, especially in the corners sometimes, right there's your contact patch. That's as big a piece of the tire that touches the track at any given moment. It's got to work and work well.
Well, you know, Greg, that was an interesting thing, but ironically, that isn't exactly true. These are radial flight tires, and as they go around, they change. The radial will absolutely stay flat. As you see, that patch looks like it's on there and inside, for sure, you're right. But boy, that tire will mold itself around bumps. That's what tire development is all about. And you do get a bigger patch sometimes. The inside tires, like you say, are wasted a lot of times. They just hold the car up.
Bobby, as we looked at the graphic, Firestone and Goodyear, Bridgestone is dominating Formula One. In fact, Michael Schumacher is quoted as saying, Michael Schumacher says that McLaren has been dominating because of the Bridgestone tires, not the drivers, not the cars. How has Firestone been able to come in so quickly and take such a lead?
Well, one of the reasons, and the big reason, Brian, is simply because Firestone is owned by Bridgestone. So they have two giant companies. The technology coming together from that. I think John Bekas has something for us right now.
Yes, and it relates to Alex Zanardi. They told him they want him to go to minus one on fuel. And they also said, well, Alex, we just want to try it. In other words, they don't think it's going to make a whole lot of power, but they're saying, let's just try as lean as we can go on the fuel to see how fast you go, because they are the masters at saving fuel till the end of the race.
And you know, the reason for that, that's interesting, John, that they would do this or Jan so early. But what it means is that they have radios talking to him, but they also have what we call telemetry. It constantly, from the race car, sends signals, radio signals to the pits. They can see how much the fuel, the engine is burning. They can see everything on the car that's happening. It's almost like the driver's a monkey sitting there.
You're looking back from the ninth car, the car in ninth place, that is Scott Pruett, looking back to Tony Kanaan. Kanaan, the rookie, is in eighth place. It's a great view, Bobby. Gives you a good sense of speed, and they reach tremendous speeds on this course.
Yeah, and you can also see how in the straightaway they seem to separate from each other like right now, but as they get to the turns, they all go up. This, the time between the two stays the same. That car right there is really not pulling up to the one to shoot the camera from. Just looks like it.
This view now as Pruett goes along Lakeshore Boulevard. Dario Franchitti still leading. Alex Zanardi, Michael Andretti is running third. And that's Richie Hearn being passed by Al Unser Jr.
That's an interesting. Now, Richie Hearn we saw spin out just a little while ago. He's probably having some handling problems right now, and they'll adjust that car as soon as they make the first pit stop, which they haven't done yet.
Bobby, Al Unser Jr., your nephew, now running in 12th place. The Budweiser car, the red car, Hearn, is running in 13th. And just ahead, there's Ribeiro in the first of the Penske cars right there, car 3 with a yellow helmet, followed by Al Unser Jr. and Richie Hearn.
You notice they're still staying right together. Ribeiro has been a little bit hard on the transmission. Both cars have transmission problems. My guess is they're having to shift very careful. Otherwise, they know they can't finish the race.
Robbie Gordon, followed by Greg Moore and Patrick Carpentier. Gordon is 14th, Moore is 15th, and Carpentier is sitting in 16th place. Down onto Lakeshore Boulevard, off in the distance is Adrian Fernandez running 17th, and by Robbie Gordon goes Greg Moore. Under braking, does not get by him. Pulled up even. Gordon was able to hold him off, and Greg Moore remains in 15th place.
And also keep in mind on that, Brian, that's a Toyota engine. Robbie Gordon, the one that's on the in the front of Greg Moore right there, the leading that little pack, that's a Toyota engine. Every year, they're getting the Toyota engine a little bit closer to the Mercedes and the Ford and the Honda and all of that, and it's a big company. They haven't grown as fast with the engines they should. Robbie Gordon is bringing a lot of life to that team.
Robbie Gordon running with Toyota power. Right behind him, Moore and Carpentier. Mercedes powered into the pits is Al Unser Jr. And down to the pits we go for Jan Vinkes. Jan?
Yes, and as we watch Al Unser Jr. get four new tires, we also heard from the Players Forsythe team that they had told Greg Moore he could use the button on the steering wheel if he needed to pass Robbie Gordon. So you talk about Toyota power. Well, that Toyota power must be powerful if it's going to take a Mercedes to use the extra power, extra fuel button for him to try and get by.
And also, Jan, I want to mention that little Al's in the pits too early by our figures. He has a problem. You might check over there with the Penske crew when you have time and see why his pit stop was so early.
On board with Michael Andretti. Michael Andretti running third behind Dario Franchitti and Alex Zanardi. That pass you saw, the green car, Franchitti, was by Gunter Salas, who is running in last place, so he has lapped the 28th car the race leader Dario Franchitti has. You're watching live coverage of the Molson Indy Toronto on CBC back after this.
Across Canada, we're making it easier to get out on the road during Canada-wide clearance. Get outstanding lease offers or 1.9% financing on virtually every vehicle, including the Chevrolet Venture. It'll have your family saying, let's go. Get into Chevy Astro with V6 power and room for eight. Or drive the security of Chevy Blazer. Or get a dependable and long-lasting Chevy pickup. The huge selection makes this a great time to buy or lease. So hit the road to your Chevrolet Oldsmobile dealer for Canada-wide clearance.
Watch carefully. 14,000 people witnessed.
Mr. Secretary, you are going to be sorry.
The crime. Only one man can see the truth. Nicholas Cage.
The redhead you follow, she's one. Shooter's two. Tyler's three. The drunk is four. Whoever was on the other end of that radio is five.
Five people make a conspiracy, right?
This is not the plan I invested in.
Get out of the way!
Snake Eyes. Friday, August 7th, everywhere.
Before he made Wendy's smoky bacon cheeseburger, Dave had a lot to do. Smoke the hickory smoked bacon, slice the processed smoked cheddar, saute the onions, plus cook up a quarter pound of fresh ground beef, and then put it all together.
It's a lot of work, but it's a lot of sandwich.
A history rich with stories of courage and character. It's made the RCMP a world-renowned police force. A remarkable tradition. In their footsteps, RCMP 125, Wednesday night.
In Toronto, and Greg Moore has just passed Robbie Gordon. So Moore is up in 13th place. That is Carpentier slowing. Here's Moore on the right going by Gordon on the left. Carpentier in the background, and he has stopped.
Now that's the hard way. That's on the outside. That's a hard pass to make right there. Usually they pass on the inside going into the turn, which is a lot safer.
Bobby, just before that replay, that is Michel Jourdain Jr. We've had a bit of a crash involving two, three, four cars. That is one of the Ganassi cars, followed, I believe, by Paul Tracy. That was Vasser going through, followed by Tracy. The yellow car looks like it belongs to Ernst Meyer from Germany. So a full course yellow here in Toronto. And we'll see via videotape just exactly what happened down after turn three. As we look down, Michel Jourdain was involved. One of the Roger Penske cars looks to be involved.
Can't tell which one. That's from the top shot there. It's impossible to tell, but the cars definitely look like they got into each other.
That is just going up beside the third baseline at Exhibition Stadium, and the race leader is into the pits. That was Franchitti. There's Carpentier, who we saw slowing.
You know, 26 laps into the race, ideal for pit stops. I got to find something good out of this whole mess right now, so it was a proper time for pit stops.
And Alex Zanardi had just brought his car onto pit road, guys, and he had a little bit of a miscue as he was coming into the box. He got the tires locked up. It took him a little bit longer. 13.2 seconds for Zanardi.
And also, when he went out, Jan, the first thing I noticed, look at him race for the first turn there, smoking the tires already. I noticed they took a little bit of front wing out of Zanardi. That means that he needs the front end to hold a little bit less, and he wants the rear end to hold a little bit more. So they made an adjustment on his car.
Well, Greg Moore and Patrick Carpentier just stopped by the pits. Routine stops both, very quick, in and out. Right now, we are just listening. That is
Christian Fittipaldi completing his stop. Andretti a good stop to parent everybody in. A little bit of an update as to what happened with Al Jr. That was actually a planned stop. They wanted to get him out of sequence and avoid some of the traffic that he was in on the track. It hurt him because we had this yellow. A lap later, he lost a lot of green track location. Tough stop for Al Jr.
That is Gilles Deferrin, who has stopped, and it looks like he could be out of this race. Michelle Jourdain involved in that collision down at the end of Lakeshore Boulevard as they went through turn three. They're now bringing Deferrin back, and they'll try and restart him. We're under a full course yellow here in Toronto. It's Dario Franchitti leading Alex Zanardi, Bobby Rahal. Here's what happened. That is Carpentier going past Robbie Gordon.
Right,
and
Carpentier
with
away.
A flat tire, it appeared, on the back left.
Yeah, well, you could see that Gordon just ran right into him and knocked the wing off of his car, and that was totally Gordon. Gave him a good punt job right there. Probably got the tire on the car. There you can, wow, look at that going in there. There's what, whoa!
That
Jourdain almost got upside down, really close to it right there.
That is Jourdain, Bobby, with young Alex Barron. Now we're on board with Michael Andretti.
Coming through their cars, blocking the place all over the place. Almost totally blocked the track. In fact, it did block it for a while.
Hopefully we'll get one more look at that. So Michelle Jourdain involved. Also involved is young Alex Barron. The race leader is Franchitti, as they've now bunched up. You can see Michael Andretti has moved into second on the yellow pit stop ahead of Zanardi. And Paul Tracy, a big story, is running fourth. Jan Vikas.
Yes, Gilles Deferrin, you saw him stopped on the course, and now he is climbing from his car. There is suspension damage on the right rear, and there's a big tire mark on the rear wing. So he made contact with another car when he was trying to leave the pits, and that is knocking Gilles Deferrin out of this competition.
Under a full course yellow in Toronto, it's Dario Franchitti, the leader. Michael Andretti with that series of pit stops, now second. Vasser has moved into third. Tracy is fourth. Zanardi is down to fifth. Kanaan is up to sixth place. The car you saw there was Alex Barron. That was involved in that shunt with Michelle Jourdain.
One of Dan Gurney's cars. One of the Toyota factory cars there. Well, a lot of action going on about the time the pit stop started happening there.
Lots of action indeed. A full course yellow and a chance for a commercial break. You're watching live coverage of the 1998 Molson Indy Toronto on CBC.
Race fans, get ready for 3 days of fast-paced, high-stakes action on the water as the Ontario Place Offshore Challenge takes to the shores of Lake Ontario, September 11th to 13th. For more information, call 416-314-9835. Tickets available through Ticketmaster by calling 416-870-8000.
It's Canada-wide clearance time, featuring 1.9% financing and excellent leases on a huge selection of most 98 models, like the sporty, fun-to-drive Pontiac Sunfire Coupe, the Pontiac Grand Prix with wide track for outstanding handling and control, the Century by Buick. Surround yourself with a surprising touch of luxury. Hurry in for Canada-wide clearance at your Pontiac, Buick, GMC dealers.
Fulfilling nature's miracle of birth, this bewildered young chick comes forth into a vast, strange world. If he's lucky, someone will give him a ClearNet PCS phone. Because this being his birthday, he'll enjoy free local calls. But, as is customary for the Western Grebe, his gifts will instead consist of regurgitated food.
Free local calls on your birthday and very affordable to use. Isn't it time you had a ClearNet PCS phone?
Back live in Toronto, still under a full course yellow. Dario Franchitti is still the race leader. Michael Andretti is second. Vasser is third. Tracy is fourth. Zanardi is running
in fifth place. There's Al Unser Jr. Unser Jr. well back. In fact, is running 27th. Full course yellow down to Jan Vinkes.
Yes, and Jill DeFerrin has climbed from the car. Let's find out what happened. Obvious contact. Who was it with?
Yeah, it was coming out of the pits. The guys did a good pit stop. When I came out, the rear swung around and I clipped Christian's left rear. I don't know if it was the wheels already there or the guy changed and unfortunately he rolled down. I really don't know which one I clipped. It's a real shame because the car was running really well, and the bubbling coming screw did a really good job in the pits here.
Now, was it the tire that was on his car or the tire that was laying on the ground?
I don't know. That's what I don't know. I know that I came out, my rear swung around, and I thought, okay, I'm going to be okay. And then as I was coming into the pit lane, my rear climbed over like this, and that was it. The suspension broke.
Tough break.
It was tough because I thought we could have done well.
Thanks.
Thank you, Jan. We understand one more lap to go, and they'll be racing again. Very quickly, let's show you why Alex Zanardi is running fifth. Here he comes down Lakeshore. He was at this point... Andretti had just gone past him. Now here's the accident, and watch what happens. He can't get through.
See, they
so
don't
he has
realize.
To stop.
They don't realize, Brian, that there's a blockage right there, and nobody could tell that line over to the left was going to be able to go through. So Zanardi, who we're on board with, is just blocked. And of course, he's clear back to fifth place now, and we just wanted to tell people that's how he got there, right?
There's Alex Barron's car. He was involved in that collision with Michelle Jourdain. So there were changes in the pits, but when we look at the tape now, we can see Zanardi was actually blocked by that accident. So there's Franchitti, followed by Andretti second. The red car is Vasser third, and Paul Tracy. Let's give Tracy full credit. He is running fourth and has driven an outstanding race here this afternoon. Greg Creamer?
Just an update on the Christian Fittipaldi situation. The contact with the Ferentz car actually affected Christian. He had to come back in because when that tire got, they had to put the old tire back on the car, get him back out on track so he didn't lose a lap. And
that is Patrick Carpentier. Carpentier has just hit the wall as we came back to green racing here in Toronto.
Now, I didn't see that one early enough to call that one, so I'll have to hold off on that one. But there they are. He's spinning around. He was going the wrong way. Now he's heading back the right way.
That's Mark Blundell, the defending champion, car 18, driving for PacWest.
Obviously, we had more than one car involved. There went Carpentier right there. Yellow probably is going to be out some places around the track at least.
There's the leader, Franchitti, followed by Michael Andretti second, Jimmy Vasser third, Paul Tracy fourth. Alex Zanardi has just now gone by Paul Tracy. So Zanardi has moved up to fourth place, dropping Tracy down to fifth. There's the leader, Franchitti, followed by Andretti, the two Chip Ganassi cars. And into the wall, one of the back markers down through the start-finish line comes the race leader, Franchitti. There is the Kmart car. That's Andretti second, followed by the two Ganassi cars, Vasser, Zanardi, Tracy in the yellow car, and Tony Kanaan, the rookie, as Bobby Rahal is passed by Gaultier Salas, now on board with Rahal, who is running seventh, though Salas is a lap down, so that does not affect the standings. The race leader down into turn three, followed by Andretti, Vasser, and Zanardi.
Look at Franchitti going in there and locking up his brakes. He's been doing that, locking up the front brakes. That means he's really driving it deep. Now, how hard is he really trying? If you watch that, you got to see he's going as hard as he can go.
Bobby Rahal is right behind Tony Kanaan. The lead is just over a second for this man, Dario Franchitti, over five-time winner Michael Andretti.
He doesn't have near the edge, and he did a little while ago. We still have a car on the course out there. Don't know why they haven't moved that one yet. Franchitti's pulling away a little bit, Brian, but he's not running away with it like he did earlier.
Dario Franchitti, 25 years of age, lives in Pompano Beach, Florida.
You can tell how hard he's driving. He's locking up his brakes, going into the turns, and he's getting the rear end loose coming out of the turns. That means he's really trying hard.
His first season with Barry Green after driving for
Hogan Racing last year when he won the pole here in Toronto. Zanardi, now all over his teammate Jimmy Vasser, we're on board with Alex Zanardi running fourth. Just in front of him, the third place car is teammate Vasser, and beyond Vasser is Michael Andretti, who's running second behind Frank Keating.
Now you can bet you, now we got a double yellow. That means yellow all the way around the course. I just started to say, you can bet you that Zanardi's not going to press too hard against Jimmy Vasser, because that's the team car.
And the yellow is out because Mark Blundell, the defending champion, has stalled his car.
I just don't think the cart guy saw that for a long time. We've been
that happened
car.
A long time ago.
We've been watching that car sit there for a long time, and I was mentioning to you, you must not see the car sitting there, because that always brings out a yellow. In fact, I said a little while ago, there should be a yellow pretty soon.
Yellow flag in Toronto, and we'll take a break. You're watching live coverage of the 1998 Molson Indy Toronto on CBC.
All across Canada, we're making it easier to get out on the road during Canada-wide clearance. Right now, get outstanding lease offers or 1.9% financing on virtually every vehicle, including the car more Canadians depend on, the Chevrolet Cavalier. And on the Chevrolet Malibu, you'll get a lot more than you expect. Or drive home in the sophisticated midsize Oldsmobile Intrigue. The huge selection makes this a great time to buy or lease. So hit the road to your Chevrolet Oldsmobile dealer for Canada-wide clearance.
The coolest game on earth now offers the coolest credit card on earth. It's the official no-annual-fee NHL MasterCard issued by NBNA Canada. Call toll-free 1-877-HOCKEY-9 and apply for the credit card featuring your favorite NHL team logo. Score with exclusive cardholder benefits and save with a low introductory annual interest rate. A credit card made for hockey fans like you. The official no-annual-fee NHL MasterCard. Call toll-free 1-877-HOCKEY-9 now to apply for your official National Hockey League MasterCard.
You've never seen anything like it, and it's headed for Canadian Tire.
More selection, more parts for more makes and models of cars and light trucks, more quality brand names like Certified Brakes, Monroe Shocks, and TRW Suspension Parts. So now, you'll get the right parts when you need them at guaranteed low prices. Canadian Tire, Canada's auto parts store.
Back in Toronto under a full course yellow, the race leader Dario Franchitti, Michael Andretti right behind him. There's Franchitti. One more lap under full course yellow, and they'll be racing again, and we go down to the pits. Here's Young Vickas. Young?
Yes, in regards to Mark Blundell, when he came to a stop out on the course, he called back to the crew and said he thought it was engine related. He brought it on the pit road. They checked it out and said, yes, in fact, it's broken. They weren't specific what was broken, and he is now out of the car. Let's go to Greg Kramer.
Well, Jan, in the case of Carpentier's pit stop, we know exactly what was broken. You can see, well, one of the crew members coming in, but you can see the damage to the nose of the car. He got into one of the walls, just grazed it, but it was just enough to upset the geometry, if you will, of the wing. They had to bring him in, had to make the change, get a clean wing on the car. Now he's set to go. But again, on this track, he's lost so much track position.
Bobby, we went so many laps without the yellows, and now this race seems to be somewhat falling apart, if you will.
Well, it'll settle down after a while, you know. First pit stop is always a lot of action, and Lord only knows we've had more than we could even keep up with today. It was happening faster than you and I could cover it, but nonetheless, it's good action. We still have a super good race. It isn't going to fall apart all the way. It's just going to be a lot of things happening, which is going to make it a better race.
From the Hilfiger airship, the shots as they'll make the right turn. They're now going up alongside the Gardiner Expressway. And we can stay with this shot. There's the leader, Franchitti. Andretti, the two red cars, Vasser and Zanardi. Paul Tracy running fifth and driving a great race this afternoon. The right-hand turn, they now go down to the old exhibition stadium. The left-hand turn, lights are out on the pace car. For the start-finish area and back racing in Toronto. Dario Franchitti followed by Michael Andretti, Jimmy Vasser, and Alex Zanardi. There's Paul Tracy, Tony Kanaan, the rookie, and veteran Bobby Unser on board with Zanardi as he chases his teammate Jimmy Vasser.
Now let's watch going down into the hairpin turn, the sharp turn at the end, best passing play. There's Michael in the black car on the left pulling up on Franchitti. right there, close. See, they need to make that pass right now. That's where he needs to make his pass before everybody gets going good, while the tires are cool and everything is positive. He tried hard, but he couldn't make it. I knew he was going to try hard on that one.
The yellow flags bunching up this field. Zanardi, to me, it's just a matter of time before Zanardi makes a move on his teammate Jimmy Vasser. This is what has made Zanardi so very, very good this year. He's fast like Paul Tracy. He's daring like Paul Tracy, but he's also willing to be patient when need be.
You know what he'll do is he'll sit right now and try to get Vasser to pull back a little bit, relax a little bit. And then Zanardi's always got a couple aces in his pocket that he doesn't show you, and then he'll zap Vasser real quick. And that's just typically his personality and the way he works it. And of course, everybody's kind of figured this out by now.
There's Andretti, second, Vasser, third, Zanardi. The cool car is Paul Tracy. Paul Tracy is running fifth. Here's Bobby Rahal. You're on board with Rahal. He is seventh. And we look ahead to one of the great stories in this race, the young rookie, Tony Kanaan, up from the Indy Lights Series last year.
He's really doing a good job. And I'll tell you, I want to throw a couple of stars towards Paul Tracy. He's really done better than I've seen him do all year so far. He's not been in any accidents. He's using good judgment. He's high up in the running right now. He's still got a good chance of winning this race.
I understand from Jan and Greg down in the pits that Patrick Carpentier is in the pits and out of his car, so it appears that Carpentier, who was running five laps down, is through for the afternoon. Bobby Rahal running seventh. There's the race leader. There's Andretti second, Vasser, Zanardi, Tracy, Kanaan, Rahal, Pruitt, Hearn, and Ribeiro.
You notice Franchitti is pulling away a little bit away from Michael again. Michael is kind of staying even with those two red cards. That's one with Vasser and Zanardi, the two red cards right there. There's Franchitti again going by, pulling away a little bit. Now there's no doubt. Whoa, look at here.
That's Greg Moore, followed by Fernandez. Moore is running 11th, followed by Fernandez, Herta, and Guzman. There's Greg Moore running 11th. Fernandez, who won 2 years ago. Brian Herta injured in a spectacular accident here several years ago in practice.
I saw a possible problem coming right there, Brian, so I had to kind of hold my breath. That turn at the end of the long straightaway. It was getting a little crowded right there. Look at this group. They're really tight. Racing is good right there.
We're back in the pack. As we look at the group from about 11 on, Greg Moore running 11th. Now back to the front of the race. There's Franchitti, Andretti, the two Ganassi cars, and Paul Tracy, who's running fourth. Remember, Paul Tracy won here in 1993.
Doing a good job right now, but the guy really doing a good job is that Franchitti. He seems to be able to pull away a little bit, either from Zanardi or Michael Andretti. And that shows that his car is still working good. His tires have had a chance to, it's been both good and been bad. He's been heavy on fuel and light on fuel. Seems to have a little bit of an edge on him all the time right now.
Paul Tracy running fourth, his teammate, running fifth, I should say, his teammate there, Dario Franchitti, the race leader. Franchitti in a Honda-powered car, the number two car, Michael Andretti with Ford Cosworth power running second, and that is the Hogan car. That would be J.J. Leto, the former Formula One driver from Finland, and Leto was running in 20th position.
He's into the tires pretty hard there. You can see the rear wing bent really bad, and of course we know the front end bent. Left front's going to be totally destroyed on that car, but you know, interestingly enough, it really helped to hit those tires. It's like going into a balloon compared to a cement wall.
Going into a balloon, but I'll tell you what, my friend, as you once told me, it could be an awfully hard balloon. A full course yellow in Toronto, and we'll return with coverage of the Molson Indy right after this.
In other countries, differences of opinion may cause persecution, imprisonment, or even war.
Before he made Wendy's smoky bacon cheeseburgers, Dave had a lot to do. Smoke the hickory smoked bacon, slice the processed smoked cheddar, saute the onions, plus cook up a quarter pound of fresh ground beef, and then put it all together.
It's a lot of work, but that's a lot of sandwich.
Race fans, get ready for 3 days of fast-paced, high-stakes action on the water as the Ontario Place Offshore Challenge takes to the shores of Lake Ontario, September 11th to 13th. For more information, call 416-314-9835. Tickets available through Ticketmaster by calling 416-870-8000.
Before he made Wendy's smoky bacon cheeseburgers, Dave had a lot to do. Smoke the hickory smoked bacon, slice the processed smoked cheddar, saute the onions, plus cook up a quarter pound of fresh ground beef, and then put it all together.
It's a lot of work, but it's a lot of sandwich.
That is J.J. Leto from Helsinki, Finland, driving for Carl Hogan. And his day is through as he hits the tires and not the cement wall, as Bobby Unser said. But as I said, those are, he says, like a balloon. I tell you what, that's a hard balloon.
You know what? Sometimes that can be $100,000 difference in the damage done. Those tires are the miracle thing.
We're under a full course yellow here in Toronto. One of the great stories today is the pace car brings this field down across the start-finish line. Updating the Canadians, Carpentier is out of this race. And speaking of Patrick Carpentier, I understand he's standing by with Greg Creamer. Greg?
Brian, indeed. Patrick, this has been a tough weekend, really, from the get-go here. What happened out there?
Yeah, it was a tough weekend. You know, we struggled a bit in qualifying, and I think we got a good car for the race. The car was pretty good, passed a lot of cars in the first lap. Then after that, I tried to pass Robbie on the inside, and I couldn't quite make it. The front was locking up. Then Robbie locked it also and hit me at the back. Then that was it. It bent the suspension. Then when I went back after that for the green flag, the suspension was a bit bent and it rotated the car too quickly and I hit the wall.
You had a couple of poles on ovals early, but you also had the fastest lap at Portland. So there's been speed on the road courses. Why have you been sort of struggling here?
Yeah, I don't know. We're still struggling a little bit on the street circuit. We got the road course, we got the oval now. It's pretty good. Street circuit, we still need to do a lot of work, and it was not our weekend this weekend.
All right, well, tough break. Good luck next time out.
Thank you.
Patrick Carpentier through for the day. The other two Canadians doing very well. Paul Tracy's running fifth and Greg Moore running 11th. The Hogan car driven by J.J. Leto still being removed from the track here in Toronto. We'll take a commercial break. We're under full course yellow. Great shot from the Hilfiger airship. You see some of the planes going into the Toronto Island Airport there on this Sunday afternoon.
Beautiful shot.
It's Canada-wide clearance time, featuring 1.9% financing and excellent leases on a huge selection of most 98 models, like the GMC Sierra, strength and style, 365 days a year, and the more than a minivan, GMC Safari, the GMC Jimny with capability and comfort, and the Pontiac Transport, the minivan that's built for drivers. Hurry in for Canada-wide clearance at your Pontiac Buick GMC dealers.
Yes? Oh, Jimmy, how nice. Oh, okay. Well, you'll need a big pot and then a stewing hen. And now, Jimmy, listen to this. Remember, no feathers. Now, ingredients, yes. Carrots, celery, garlic, parsnip, and, of course, salt. No, it's not chicken stock yet. And then you boil it beyond recognition. You fish out the carcass, and voila!
Tonight... Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. The hit movie is now a TV show. And shrinking is just the beginning. Then...
I dare you to go back there.
The delightful Emily of New Moon returns.
What do you wear this for?
There's a touch of Lucifer in that child.
I'm always doing what other people say.
You never do what other people say.
Tonight on CBC...
Under a full course yellow in Toronto, just about halfway through this race, you're on board with Alex Zanardi, who's running fourth and following his third place teammate Jimmy Vasser. Dario Franchitti leads, Michael Andretti's second, and as we're riding with Zanardi under this full course yellow,
Let's go down to the pits for more on Zanardi. Once again, Jan Vinkus, yeah?
Yes, and Alex Zanardi has been given a warning from CART because when he left the pits here last time, he got very close to getting four wheels over the yellow line. And, of course, he's in the very last pit stall as far as leaving pit road. So if you get on the gas really hard and you swing the back of the car out, he came very close to crossing that all-important yellow line. They warned him. They're not going to give him a penalty. He radioed back and said, thank you very much. I won't do it again. Alex Zanardi right now, thankful he didn't have to come in and make a stop and go.
And you know, Jan, I'll explain that a little bit more. When you leave the pits, they have a line that's there for safety. So if the car guys make a green flag stop, the fast cars going by won't hit the slower cars. So Zanardi is in the last pit, as you said. He comes out, his rear end gets to run a little bit wild because he's spinning his tires, and he gets over the yellow line a little bit. Really didn't hurt anything under the yellow, but they have to have rules to fit everything. There's a yellow line right there that we're talking about. Pretty easy to do, incidentally.
The cleaners are still on the track. As you see the big machine on the right of the screen, we're under a full course yellow here in Toronto. And once again, we go back down to the pits.
And the reason that we are still under yellow, and you may see it on the start-finish straightaway, is a sweeper. They have dispatched the sweepers around the racetrack to take care of those marbles that you and Bobby were talking about. They want to give these drivers the opportunity to have clear racing going into these corners because, as we have spoken about, towards the end of the race here in Toronto, oftentimes there's no passing because of the marbles on the racetrack. CART wants to get rid of them so we can see some great racing to the finish.
You know, Brian, I know right now everybody could get a little disgusted with that concept, but by the same token, it makes racing so much better. You just literally can't pass, as we've told the people for so many years here later on in the race, unless you get those marbles up and get them gone, because all it is the tire comes off the tires, Firestone and Goodyear, the rubber compounds don't mix together, so there ends up being little balls all over the racetrack. It's like driving on peanuts or gravel or something.
I guess we could say this is one time that you'd like to lose your marbles.
Yeah, there you go. That was a good one.
With Bobby Unser. The pace car lights are out with Bobby Unser, Jan Vinkus, and Greg Creamer. I'm Brian Williams. We're in Toronto. Just about halfway through this 98-lap race, there's your race leader, Dario Franchitti, followed by Michael Andretti. Andretti ready to go. There's Vasser. There's Zanardi, and there's Paul Tracy driving very well as running fifth. Canaan, the rookie, is sixth. Bobby Rahal, seventh. As they come down through the start-finish line, the pace car is off the track, and we're racing again in Toronto. Top seven, eight, nine cars right on each other's tail. Across the start-finish line goes the leader, Franchitti. There's Andretti. Vasser, Tony Canaan goes by Paul Tracy. What a move by the LCI car and the rookie, Tony Canaan.
And that's the place to do it. As we've been saying, you must do it really early on because it's so hard to pass on this track. Look at Zanardi, tucked right under Vasser. Right there, Zanardi we on board with. Look at him, oh, he's going by. Almost got pushed into the wall right there by Vasser. Both of them doing good, neither one doing anything wrong. Good racing.
Outstanding racing as we're on board with Alex Zanardi, and we saw just a tremendous pass by the 23-year-old from Sao Paulo, Brazil, Tony Canaan. There's Franchitti, Andretti, and there's Canaan in the yellow car at the top of your screen, just in front of Paul Tracy.
And you know, he did that pass, Brian, in the hardest place going into turn one. I would have thought he'd have tried to be in the long straightaway, but that's what makes good race drivers. They try to outthink the other one.
Canaan, another in a long list of Brazilian drivers.
Now there's Franchitti, there's Michael Andretti. Look at these two red cars. Zanardi didn't get by Vasser now. There's a teammate, and we know he tried hard on that one.
It is just a matter of time before the second red car there, the second target car. Alex Zanardi tries to go by Vasser. There's Andretti. Vasser in the first target car. Zanardi does not get him on the inside, followed by the rookie Canaan and Canadian Paul Tracy. There's the veteran Bobby Rahal. Behind Rahal, Pruitt, Hurd, and Ribeiro. Now, let's have a look at this pass. Take us through it. Tony Canaan, left of your screen.
Nobody, Paul Tracy did not think. They're really three abreast right then. Nobody thought. They left the door wide open for Canaan. He took it. He went for it. That shows a good driver. Young, inexperienced, but good. Look at him squeeze right through there. Nothing Tracy could do. He was there before Paul even knew it.
Greg Creamer. Well, he also took advantage of an opportunity. I just checked in again with Barry Green, and Barry said their setup on the car, it's taking a little bit longer for Paul's tires to come up to temp after a long yellow. Kanaan's car gets there a little quicker, and he made the pass.
And let's take nothing away from the 23-year-old Brazilian. In his rookie year with Tasman Racing, there's Craig Moore. Craig Moore, the second of two Canadians still running. Moore is running 12th, followed by Christian Fittipaldi, Adrian Fernandez, Michael Andretti. Now, that's Christian Fittipaldi right behind Craig Moore. Michael Andretti closing in on the race leader, Franchitti, but he is still second. And now, Christian Fittipaldi has passed Craig Moore. Fittipaldi is 12th and Moore is 13th. Something wrong with Moore, do you think?
Yes, absolutely, because you don't pass a guy that easy, especially in that part of the track. That's a place where they really don't pass. And he got him really easy, so Moore's got something wrong. He's not handling good.
Back to the front of the race. There's Vasser third, there's Zanardi fourth, there's Kanaan the rookie fifth, followed by Paul Tracy. I think Zanardi's just waiting to get down to the end of Lakeshore Boulevard and make a move on Vasser.
You know, he really tried hard, Brian, honestly. Good. Jimmy Vasser, when he has good days, he's really good. Now that Zanardi needs to get by his teammate Vasser there. Look at there. Now, you can't try any harder than that. If I didn't make my point right there, I'll never make it again. Zanardi can't try any harder. Vasser got in, never smoked a tire. Zanardi's got to go faster in there, otherwise he can't pass it.
We're looking back from Scott Pruitt's car. Pruitt is currently running eighth, so that's Richie Hearn behind him, who's ninth. Some great directing today by Jim Marshall and Chris Elias, our technicians, providing us with great, great pictures. There's Ray Hall. There's the car you were looking back from, the Visteon car, and there's the Budweiser car coming up behind it, Richie Hearn.
Notice they're getting a little bit spread apart now. The best passing always happens when the tires are cold. Back to the same thing again, after a yellow or something like that. When that happens, you can expect anything to happen. We saw some real super good passes and some better attempts that made it didn't work.
Zanardi still trying to get by Jimmy Vasser. On board with Zanardi, the PPG points leader, trying to make it four in a row, and he does not go by his teammate.
He's sure worried. Even look at that Kanaan back there. He's riding a tall cart right now. He's out there with some pretty fast guys.
And speaking of Zanardi, the crew has radioed to him and said, we want you to go to minus one on fuel, and then if you're trying to make a move on Jimmy Vasser, we want you to use the button on the steering wheel. The idea being that he can save fuel for most of the lap, and if he wants to pass, he can go for the passing button, use some extra fuel, and see if that'll get it done.
See, the passing button gives them more horsepower, squirts more fuel in there just momentarily while they're holding it, as John was telling us about there, and that gives them more horsepower, but you know, it's awful hard to run in traffic like that and have time to be pushing these buttons at the same time.
Boy, great shots from this Hilfiger airship as they come down Lakeshore Boulevard. And Zanardi does not get by him again.
I even move in my seat watching that one. Zanardi's front tires were just smoking just a little bit going in there. Vasser's sitting there thinking, I'm wearing out his tires, wearing out his brakes, and making an old man out of him trying to pass.
What do you mean moving in your seat? You just knocked over our floor director, Peter Rutherford. Unser standing and jumping up and down here in our booth.
That's good racing, Brian. I mean, this is really good.
And one of the great stories is the young Brazilian, Tony Kanaan. There's the race leader, Franchitti. You see the distance between him and Michael Andretti, who is second.
We almost lose track of the fact that Franchitti's out leading this race. We're looking at those two red cars so much.
There's Kanaan, the yellow car. There's Paul Tracy, followed by Bobby Rahal, Pruitt, Hearn. And there's Ribeiro in the first of the Roger Penske cars here this afternoon. Some outstanding racing so far. Rahal, who who's running seventh, following Tracy, who's sixth, followed by Pruitt. Hearn on board now with Bobby Rahal as he tries to catch Paul Tracy. Tracy has been up as high as fourth this afternoon, back down to sixth, and of course we saw him drop when Tony Kanaan made that great move on the inside going into turn one.
I bet he's still sitting there thinking over that, thinking, my Lord, I was worried about the other guys. I wasn't worried about that rookie behind me that just came out of Indy Lights last year.
Bobby,
that was a good pass.
We're on board with Bobby Rahal. We'll stay with Rahal for just a minute. A lot of people say that too many drivers don't know when to retire. He's in his mid-40s. This is his last year, but he is still a competitive racer.
Oh, he's very competitive. I mean, that Rahal, if he gets his car right, he's untouchable. We watched him down to Brazil like last year. I mean, anything was ever good for the old folks, they should have watched Rahal that day. He was literally untouchable. Right now, he's working on that Tracy really hard. He's not done by any means. He just wants to be a business guy and own the team, though, and not be a race driver anymore.
Here is one of the great stories. Zanardi chasing his teammate Jimmy Vasser. Vasser, the Californian, the 96 PPG champion. Zanardi, the defending champion. There's the race leader, Franchitti, followed by Michael Andretti. But the story is Franchitti comes down in front of the pit sweeps and across the start-finish line with the Toronto skyline in the background. There's Andretti. The story is, when will Zanardi pass Jimmy Vasser?
You know, a heck of a right there with Franchitti. A heck of an advantage for him today, because you notice he never has to race another car. He's led every lap of the race. He has no traffic to worry about, except occasionally he catches a slow guy that he laps and can pass most any place on the track. So it looks easy for him, and it is. But if Michael, for example, ever got by him, the things would change so fast you wouldn't believe.
You're watching live coverage of the 98 Molson Indy Toronto. It's still Franchitti, followed by Andretti, Vasser, and Zanardi.
The coolest game on earth now offers the coolest credit card on earth. It's the official no-annual-fee NHL MasterCard issued by NBNA Canada. Call toll-free 1-877-HOCKEY-9 and apply for the credit card featuring your favorite NHL team logo. Score with exclusive cardholder benefits and save with a low introductory annual interest rate. A credit card made for hockey fans like you. The official no-annual-fee NHL MasterCard. Call toll-free 1-877-HOCKEY-9 now to apply for your official National Hockey League MasterCard.
Across Canada, we're making it easier to get out on the road during Canada-wide clearance. Get outstanding lease offers or 1.9% financing on virtually every vehicle, including the Chevrolet Venture. It'll have your family saying, let's go. Get into Chevy Astro with V6 power and room for eight. Or drive the security of Chevy Blazer. Or get a dependable and long-lasting Chevy pickup. The huge selection makes this a great time to buy or lease. So hit the road to your Chevrolet Oldsmobile dealer for Canada-wide clearance.
Hey, Mr. Ragweed, you annoyed me for years. Well, no more.
Ragweed sufferers everywhere are discovering Reactum.
Now it's my turn to annoy you!
Eat dirt, you little squeak.
Want some water? Can't have it.
Reactum against Ragweed. Works fast, lasts 24 hours.
And for my finale,
I'm gonna make you watch this next commercial.
And as we're back live in Toronto, piloting the Hilfiger Athletics airship today, Captains Mike Fitzpatrick and Mark Van Beest, the ship one of the largest and most technically advanced in the world, as we look down on Alex Zanardi pursuing Jimmy Vasser on Lakeshore Boulevard. Vasser is third. Zanardi still can't get by him. He's fourth. They're both trailing Michael Andretti and Dario Franchitti. There's Scott Pruitt, followed by Richie Hearn. Into the pits is Ribeiro, driving for Roger Penske. Now, Ribeiro was running fairly well.
They see him rock that car back and forth. That tells me they've got transmission problems again, Brian, and they're racing the back end off the ground. Going to see what happens with transmission. They've got to get that transmission fixed on that car before they can develop much more.
Michael Andretti, trying to win in Toronto for the sixth time, trying to win for the second time so far this season. Behind him, Jimmy Vasser. And a quick glimpse of Alex Zanardi. And we ride with Andretti. An interesting story here. Talk about Swift and the American chassis, the American car, the Ford engines.
Well, to begin with, the people should realize that almost every car here is made in England. With the exception of this one right here, the black one that Mario's driving, that's a Swift, American-made out in California. Just started kind of like last year, or maybe the year before was the first one they built at all. Carl Haas, who owned this team, used to be the Lola distributor. He got into a fight with Lola, says, to heck with you, I'm just going to go build my own car. He made a deal with Swift. He's become like the factory entry, and the car is fast. Doing good. Michael wins races. He runs fast. He's been second all day today with it.
Bobby, if we can stay on this shot, Chris Elias, watch Andretti shift. And Bobby, talk to us about clutching and shifting.
Well, the shift, for example, you don't see him go to the left or the right working around. It's a sequential shift. He just goes back and forth. Like if they're in sixth, they go to and they want to go to second, they go six, five, four, three, two. In other words, they can't go from sixth to like second. It's like a motorcycle transmission, exactly the same way what we call a sequential box. Now, but it's good. Look how easy it shifts. He doesn't even put any effort into that. He can really pop it with two little fingers. Now, in the old days, we used to get big blisters from shifting those things.
Shifts,
really high-tech transmission.
Shifts, of course, with his right hand. There he is.
Right. It takes no thoughts. It takes no energy to do it. And he doesn't have blisters when the race is over. Doesn't have to spend a lot of time in his driving shifting. Spends his time concentrating on the road and where he needs to go.
While you were on board with Michael Andretti, there's a shot of Andretti as he comes down pursuing the race leader, Franchitti. There's Andretti. You see the distance back to Vasser and Zanardi. But it was a good point you made about Dario Franchitti. Franchitti having really an open track and being able to drive without much traffic.
The luckiest guy today so far has obviously been Franchitti. The second luckiest guy has been Michael right there, the black car, because nobody's pushing him really hard and he can't quite get to Franchitti, so he's kind of just left alone. And that's not too bad up to a point.
Bobby, I asked you yesterday in the preview show as we're on board with Zanardi, I said, look, Zanardi and Vasser have basically got the same equipment. Why has Zanardi been so superior? He had an interesting answer. He said that he's just a great driver. It's all happening for him on this course. But we all thought Zanardi was superior to Vasser, yet Vasser's been able to hold him off here this afternoon.
That's because it's so hard to pass here right now. I hate to say it, but it's the truth. If Zanardi were to get ahead of Jimmy Vasser, he would absolutely pull away. He wouldn't run away from it. Because Jimmy is fast. He has days and he's untouchable. But he's not normally as fast right here in Toronto as Alex Zanardi is. So if it does switch around pretty soon, I think he'll probably pull away. Now that's if Vasser doesn't cause him to wear his tires out. Trying to pass.
Very quickly down to the pits. We're standing by with Andre Ribeiro. And Andre, this is a track that really takes its toll on transmissions. We understand you had a gearbox problem.
Yeah, we are developing. This gearbox, unfortunately, has been breaking quite a lot. But we have good people working down there. We have a test next week. I hope we can solve this problem soon and go racing.
Is it a problem specific to one gear, or is it with the design of the entire box?
No, it's a brand new car, brand new gearbox. And we have just to experiment, to explore more, learn about it, and make it more reliable.
All right, Andre, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Greg. That is the Alumex car driven by the youngster Helio Castro Navas, and he's been able to hold off Maurizio Guzman. We're back now to the race leader. There's Franchitti. Now look at this. Coming up on Andretti are both Vasser and Zanardi. They're closing on Michael Andretti.
Now, as they go, as they get closer like this, everybody will try harder. Who's in the biggest problem? Obviously, is Jimmy Vasser, the red car right in between the two. He's got to try to get Michael, but he looks behind. He's got Zanardi trying to chew on him. So any mistake by him will be really costly.
A puff of smoke come out of Michael's car there.
That was the braking, over braking. Got in there too deep right there, and he locks his tires up. Well, the tires are hot right now. The rubber, a lot of it is gone, Brian. It's very slippery right now. Remember, we're looking at around the 65th lap for the next pit stop that's already come around to the 60th. So the tires are just about gone by now.
Michael Andretti second, Jimmy Vasser third, Zanardi's fourth, and a big gap back to Tony Kanaan is running fifth. Paul Tracy is in the points and running sixth.
Now you can bet the Ganassi team, the two red cars right there, the Ganassi team is telling those guys, Don't screw up now. Don't wreck each other. Do the best you can. Try to get Michael, but don't risk it. Pretty soon they'll have fresh tires on and a fresh load of fuel, and that will take them till the end of the race. That's when the race has to kind of start with their teammates like this.
Alex Zanardi trying to make it four in a row as he chases his teammate Jimmy Vasser. Coming up within the next five or six laps will be the second and final pit stops for those cars still racing here in Toronto.
And talking about those final pit stops, we just heard from Team Cool Green, our leader Dario Franchitti is planning on pitting on lap number 66.
66, that's only one lap off of what we guessed on, and he's going to stretch it now as far as he can, because naturally everybody would like to pit under yellow. For example, whoa, there's Tony Kanaan in the pits right now. He's early on this sequence of pits laps. That's 61 left, Brian.
He's dropped down to 11th from fifth place, but he, of course, will pick up places, and he's had trouble. He stalled.
Killed the engine. He killed the engine. And look at there. They squirt water all over, squirting right in the face. He's had a fire. He's got a fire. He's coming out. You can't see the alcohol, so out he comes. It's so confusing. Now, by now, they don't even know if there's a fire or not a fire. Confusion happens. Remember, alcohol burns clear. You can't see it.
Talk to me about the fuel. It is methanol, and the reason they use it is water will put it out. However, you don't see it. Is that right?
It's just a lot safer than gasoline. It never burns as hot. It still burns hot enough to burn you. But nobody got hurt in this melee right there. Everything is going to turn out all right, except it's going to cost the race.
There's Kanaan. He's visibly upset. I'm not sure whether he's burnt, but visibly upset because he was running so very, very well after that spectacular pass of Paul Tracy.
That's really a sad thing to have happen, and it doesn't happen very often anymore. And, you know, from right here, we couldn't see the flames going because, again, the methanol alcohol.
Spin! I believe that's Zanardi. It is Zanardi.
And who could be better than to spin around than him?
The donut Look man with a half a donut is back in this race.
He didn't lose hardly anything.
It's unbelievable.
If the yellow comes up, he'll be right back there, believe me.
But back to Tony Kanaan, the young man from Brazil, from Sao Paulo, Brazil, came up from Indy Lights, had driven so very, very quickly. The viewers might have seen some of the, there's the race leader, Franchitti, and I believe he's coming into the pits.
There's Zanardi locked up completely. Look at the flat spot on his right front tire. Blisters on the right front tire. His right front tire is blistered. This is the reason he can't brake going in there.
Michael Andretti's in the pits.
Michael Andretti is in the pits. A very quick stop. Boy, they got the tires done very quickly. Got the fuel in. They took a little extra time to top it off. He has got a brilliant stop by the Newman Haas crew.
13 seconds even for Michael Andretti as he comes back out. That is Adrian Fernandez going by him. So Fernandez will be 11th, and Andretti will be 12th. There's Dario Franchitti, who has yet to pit, the race leader.
Interesting, though. We caught Zanardi's tires a little while ago. Interesting again. His tires, front tires, have blisters on them. That means that the tires are holding air, but they don't really do much anymore. So he needs a pit stop so bad to get back in this run.
Franchitti, you see the lead. There's Vasser, the second place car, now just coming across the start finish line. There is Zanardi. He'll be followed by Paul Tracy. You just got a glimpse of Paul Tracy, who is now running fourth.
None of the three that you're talking about have pitted yet. Try to keep everybody follow the pit stops. These three cars, Vasser right there, not pitted. Franchitti, not pitted yet. We're in the lap 64 already, Brian. Zanardi, not pitted. Did his donut there for her. Spinning around.
Well, half
not pitted yet.
You saw Paul Tracy going through.
And he hasn't pitted either. 65th lap coming up next time around.
Here comes Alex Zanardi, who's running third behind Franchitti. And his teammate Jimmy Vasser.
Front tires of Zanardi's car, remember, not good. Look at the blister. You can see them as they go around there.
Watch on the left side of the screen. It's the right front tire, but it's the left side of the screen as you look at it as he's into the pits now. Now it's the right side of the screen, the right tire. You really can't see it that well on this shot.
Into the pits comes Zanardi. Greg Creamer.
Zanardi is in. He hits the mark, and those rooted front tires, they are going out. They're putting stickers on, so he's got the freshest of possible compounds. An awful lot of rubber buildup up and around the controllers on the front wing. Obviously, he's been using those tires up. He has got another very quick stop. He's away.
His stop considerably quicker than Michael Andretti's, who was 13 seconds. There's Andretti. And just coming back onto the course.
That should be Paul Tracy.
That is
right
Paul
there.
Tracy.
Yes, Paul Tracy also made a pit stop, a very quick pit stop for Paul Tracy. He was in and out about the same speed as Michael.
Look at this, speaking of Andretti, Andretti and Zanardi, wheel to wheel on Lakeshore Boulevard, and Zanardi goes through first ahead of Michael Andretti.
Boy, that was close. Now, those guys were really having an argument about who was going to be good on that.
And the leader is in. Dario Franchitti has brought his car to a stop. They're going to do a routine change. They drop it off the jacks. He's waiting for the fuel. 11 points.
That was a bad stop. That was a good stop right there, too.
Jimmy Vasser is in as well, and oh, they did a little bit of a pause, but Vasser, having one of his best runs, is out, and the crew very happy with that stop as well. Rahal looked to be coming in soon.
Now the tires are brand new when these guys leave. They're skittish around, they're sliding around a little bit. Takes a little bit before they get warmed up.
All right, let me reset it. Bobby Rahal is now the race leader. Scott Pruitt is second. Franchitti is running third. Brian Herta is fourth. Vasser is fifth. Christian Fittipaldi is sixth. You're looking at Michael Andretti, who is running in 10th place, just ahead of Alex Zanardi. Correct that now. Michael is ninth. Zanardi is 10th. Here's the pass as Michael Andretti goes in front of Alex Zanardi.
But it's all go keep in mind, explain that, that all these other cars that are ahead of these guys haven't pitted yet. They'll be going to the pits one at a time. So we think when it all settles down, the same guy's going to be up in front, but obviously Zanardi right there is ahead of Michael. We're aboard with Michael Andretti right here. That was the pit stop that got him there. Look how hard Michael's working on it, trying to get Zanardi to make a mistake, trying to get a wheel under in some way where he can just get by a little bit. Look at this. Whoa!
Michael Andretti goes by Jimmy Vasser, and now Zanardi right behind Vasser.
Super pass. Now that's the best one of the race so far, Brian. That was a hard one.
Michael Andretti has moved up to sixth place. The race leader, Brian Herta, followed by Bobby Rahal. Remember, though, Herta and Rahal and Christian Fittipaldi is third, have yet to pit. Franchitti has pitted, and he is running fourth, followed by Michael Andretti. Oh, look at this, Zanardi and Vasser wheel to wheel. That is Gaultier Salas down at the end of Lakeshore Boulevard, driving car 34, normally driven by Dennis Vitolo.
Engine's dead, he's stopped for sure. That's going to have to bring about a yellow flag. We'll see what happens from that. That's going to be a factor that we haven't seen yet.
Michael Andretti is now running sixth, followed by the two Chip Ganassi cars. There's Vasser and Zanardi.
And you know, right now, Zanardi has to try extra hard to get by Vasser, which you say he's doing, and the reason is the tires are going to go away pretty soon. He makes the pass with all the marbles, you see, inside and outside the racetrack. He's got to try it now, no matter what, because if he can't do it now, it isn't going to happen later.
Gaultier Salas at the end of Lakeshore Boulevard. Here's how it happened. That's Al Unser Jr. on the right, Arn Meyer in the yellow car. Locks them up and bangs. Whoa,
that was almost a really bad wreck. I mean, broke the car pretty good, too. He's out for certain, sure.
He hit Al Unser Jr. very, very hard. Dario Franchitti has now reclaimed the race lead with Herta coming into the pits. We have a full course yellow here in Toronto. So right now, it's Dario Franchitti, the race leader. You're looking at Michael Andretti, followed by Vasser and Zanardi.
So don't leave, folks, because you're going to see after we go from yellow back to green, we're going to see this action all over again.
Christian Fittipaldi is back on the race course, and he is running seventh, just ahead of Brian Herta and Scott Pruitt. The change is happening very, very fast. There's Andretti, followed by Vasser
and Zanardi. As they go by the accident, it is no longer a full course yellow. So Andretti is running. No full course caution, they're saying, from the start-finish line. There's Michael Andretti, followed by Jimmy Vasser and Zanardi. Andretti is now running second. Vasser is third, Zanardi is fourth, and Franchitti is back leading the race. So what's happened, Bobby, and we've got to bring the viewers up to date, with all the pit stops, those slower cars that took the lead pitted, and it's now back to the way we should see it until the end of the race. Well, Franchitti followed by Andretti, Vasser, Zanardi, and Rahal. That's Christian Fittipaldi.
Another one having problems. I have to explain my fault. I really thought there was going to be a full course yellow, and then we would go back like from a yellow to a green again and see some really good first lap passing. Well, unfortunately, listen, Cart didn't call a full course yellow, so I...
Yeah, but you're allowed one mistake.
Thank
you. It happens every race. All right. As we look at Christian Fittipaldi, who was running in sixth place, they try to get him back in this race. They are racing. It's Dario Franchitti, the race leader. There he is. That's Arne Meyer, not a factor in this race. Meyer is down in 17th place and has just been lapped the yellow car. There goes the race leader, Dario Franchitti, through the start-finish area. Michael Andretti is a distant second, followed closely by Vasser and Zanardi. We don't even see the second place cars coming through yet. Look at the distance. There is the second place car of Andretti, followed by Jimmy Vasser, Alex Zanardi, Bobby Rahal is fifth, and Paul Tracy is now running sixth. Jan Vikas.
Christian Fittipaldi, the reason that he was stopped on course is he had just left the pits on cold tires. He got down towards the end of the straightaway, got on the brakes, and the car got away from him. So he tried to go too quick, too soon on cold tires. Let's check in with Greg Kramer.
Well, Jan, Bobby was talking about the surprise of not getting the full course yellow. I think maybe Andretti's crew would have been lobbying pretty strong for just that. They stopped a couple laps earlier than anybody else. A full course yellow may have erased any questions they had about fuel and making it to the end. Right now, he may have to back off and conserve a little bit more than anybody else.
On board with Michael Andretti, you see the what looks like an antenna.
It's a camera right
there.
That's
a camera right
there. That's the onboard camera. That's right.
That's the shot.
You of all guys know onboard camera.
That's the shot to get looking ahead. And there's Michel Jourdain, pursued by Christian Fittipaldi. Christian Fittipaldi dropped way back in the field. He's running in 17th place. There's Vasser and Zanardi. Zanardi is running fourth.
They've separated a bunch right now. Brian, look how far apart they are. So I think what's happened now is Alex tried Vasser as hard as he could, as long as he could, and Lord only knows he really tried hard. Couldn't pass Vasser. He's going to have to settle back for a little bit. Wait till he gets closer to the end of the race. See if maybe Vasser has a weakness. Maybe his front end gets looser, his rear end gets loose. Maybe he can try this again.
On board with Alexander Zanardi, Alessandro Zanardi, as he pursues Jimmy Vasser. Alex Zanardi is running in fourth place. We'll take a break. You're watching live coverage of the Molson Indy Toronto.
It's Canada-wide clearance time, featuring 1.9% financing and excellent leases on a huge selection of most 98 models, like the sporty, fun-to-drive Pontiac Sunfire Coupe. The Pontiac Grand Prix with wide track for outstanding handling and control. The Century by Buick. Surround yourself with a surprising touch of luxury. Hurry in for Canada-wide clearance at your Pontiac, Buick, GMC dealers.
Daddy!
On this critically acclaimed series, A New Beginning.
He wants to move back to Los Angeles. You guys have settled here.
Working to make a life.
I need you to back me on this.
Putting the pieces back together.
Either he's back or he's not.
You and the kids have been holding your breath for 6 months now.
They're trying to squeeze me out.
I want you to bring the kids back to L.A.
You are so selfish.
We're gonna have a restaurant.
What if nobody comes?
Black Harbor, Wednesday on CBC. This summer, CBC brings you the best of National Geographic. Go to where the animals roam. From dark oceans to leafy treetops. From murky swamps to mountain vistas. See the wild, untamed side of life. National Geographic Specials begins July 30th on CBC.
With Bobby Unser, Jan Vikason, Greg Creamer, I'm Brian Williams, back live in Toronto. 21 laps to go. The race leader seen here is 25-year-old Dario Franchitti from Edinburgh, Scotland. He leads Michael Andretti. Jimmy Vassar's third. Alex Zanardi fourth. Bobby Rahal fifth. Paul Tracy is running in sixth place. Tracy is Franchitti's teammate. The other Canadian still running, Greg Moore, is 10th. Patrick Carpentier dropped out of this race earlier.
Look at those beautiful shots from up high, Brian.
That's Michael Andretti.
And the black car on the left, right there.
Vasser's right behind him.
Yep.
They are running second and third, respectively.
Notice that Zanardi is back. Probably just not wore his race car out trying to pass everybody.
As Vasser makes a move on Andretti, there comes Zanardi. Let's once again go down to the pits and join Jan Vikason.
In regards to Dario Franchitti, he made an incredibly quick pit stop, so the question would be, did they get all the fuel in the car? According to Barry Green, they did get all the fuel in the car, which means on the lap that they stopped, they should have plenty of fuel to go the distance and give Dario Franchitti as much power as they need. So a lot of very excited people down here at Team Cool Green.
Well, there we're on board with Bobby Rahal right now.
Bobby Rahal is running fifth, just ahead of Paul Tracy. So it's been quite a day for, as we look at Bobby Rahal, been quite a day for Team Green and Barry Green. Dario Franchitti leads this race, and Paul Tracy is standing sixth. Bobby Rahal won here in 1986, running in Toronto for the last time. On board with Rahal, take us down Lakeshore, Bobby.
Well, this is the place where we've seen a lot of the action. This is where we saw the big car park down there, the blockage earlier, breaking hard. This is where the passing usually happens. Right down here to the right, about 160 degree turns, real quick around the left, wide open through here, 90 degree to the left right here. Tough one. Now, we normally don't see any passing in there, but today we have seen a little bit.
Dario Franchitti now opening up a large lead over Michael Andretti. He's got a lead of about 15, 18 seconds.
And he can afford to be choosy and careful right now. 25 years old. I hope he's got enough experience to really take it easy on that car, because he's just about to win his first race here.
Well, as we look at Franchitti, he won the 1994 British Formula 3 Championship driving for Paul Stewart, who is the son of the great Jackie Stewart. His best finish so far this year was second on a course you know well, Long Beach. There's Michael Andretti, who's running second, followed by Vasser, who's third, and you're right, Zanardi has pulled well back of his teammate, Jimmy Vasser.
But Vasser is working hard on Michael. Now, he's not getting this close without some ideas of trying something. Vasser's not a quitter. When Vasser's hot, he's hot. Now, we've watched Zanardi can't pass him all day. We thought Zanardi might have been a little bit faster, but now look at Jimmy. He's getting up there. He's working on Michael. He's still got a lot of laps to go yet.
Michael Andretti, who won at Miami this year, but hasn't won since. Vasser's close to Andretti. There's Zanardi. And there comes Bobby Rahal off in the distance, running fifth, followed by Paul Tracy in sixth place.
I don't think I've ever seen Zanardi give up like this. I mean, he's falling back a little bit. I don't mean giving up completely, but gosh, you know, the Alex Zanardi we know would be wearing something out, probably his clothes or the tires or something, trying to get the faster, and he seems to be happy laying back right now.
There's Scott Pruitt, followed by Richie Hearn. They are running seventh and eighth, respectively. Bobby, we should point out at this point in the race that not only does Dario Franchitti stand to win, as Pruitt is followed by Richie Hearn, his first ever kart race, he stands to win the Marlboro Pole Award, which today is $280,000. That is for starting on the pole and winning the race. That is, oh my, that's Franchitti.
That is bad news for everybody.
Look at this. Vasser or Zanardi went over top of the nose, and that is a turn one. It's where he had trouble last year. Remember in the
I don't believe lap. This. I really don't. Look at that. The other two cars of the same team picked into each other.
Paul Tracy.
This has got to be unbelievable, Brian. This I would have not predicted in 100 years happening.
Paul Tracy has just run into his teammate, Dario Franchitti.
Look at Dario blocking at almost all the track, right where the cars need to come out, looking very green. He's thinking, how can this happen to me? I'm sorry I hated to jump on you, but man, I can't believe this one.
Now we saw one of the two Chip Ganassi cars, the right rear wheel of Ganassi's car.
We think that was Zanardi.
We're not sure. It was Zanardi. Go over the front of Franchitti. Franchitti now getting out of the car. They're pushing Paul Tracy off to the side.
Franchitti had no reason. He just plain lost it.
That's on that cement. They complained about that cement.
But Brian, he is so far ahead. He had no reason to do that. That was, in my book, that was ridiculous. That showed no professionalism. He really shouldn't have done that. There's Michael. Where do you go? Look at Michael trying to go by there. He's got to go. The rear of Michael's car. It should have touched his nose. We didn't see it, but it should have. Let me see here. Look at Vasser.
That's Vasser.
Over the front tire, over the rear tire. Vasser's going to be lucky. There went Zanardi. He got on by on the right. Vasser lost a position on that. What a big change.
Here's on board with Zanardi. See, Vasser on the left, and Zanardi was able to pass his teammate, so Zanardi is now second behind, who did you say at the top of the show? Michael Andretti.
I know. It's exciting. Look at that. Look at Vasser go over. I just cannot believe this. Frank Kitty's got to be sitting there thinking, my gosh, I really screwed up after such a good race all day. Super good race he's had all day. No nose left, wings are bent, lots of problems. Totally blocking, they were not totally blocking, but for all practical purposes, their cars are going fast, he was totally blocking the racetrack.
Well, Bobby, we'd all but given this race to young Dario Franchitti. It was, I'll tell you what, it was about this time yesterday when he was walking back. Remember, you said, what is he, a movie star? He was waving to the people and they were cheering him. It is a very different walk for the young Scotsman here this afternoon.
It shows you it's not over till it's over, because you and I had already said he's got such a tremendous lead. He can't screw up, make any mistakes now, but it shows you maybe a lacking in experience sometimes pays itself off in funny ways.
We're trying to see what Franchitti has to say. Here's Paul Tracy. And boy, Franchitti's
no place to go. I mean, Paul thinks he looks to the left, he looks to the right. Where would you go if you were him? I can't blame Paul Tracy for that at all.
So Tracy is still running right now, but as you say, Paul Tracy's been criticized for many things. This will not be one of them.
No way. He's innocent. He did a good job all day. Nobody will say anything bad about Paul Tracy today, I promise you.
Well, Paul Tracy was running up in fifth place, has now dropped down to 13th under a full course yellow. Michael Andretti is the race leader. Zanardi second, Vasser's third, Rahal fourth, Herta fifth, Pruett is sixth, Hearn is seventh, Moore is now moved up to eighth, Max Pappas is ninth, Fernandez is running 10th, and the Franchitti car leaves the course, Bobby Unser.
Yeah, and you know, just think about Barry Green. I mean, one of the nicest owners that I've ever known in IndyCar, and he sees both of his cars, for all practical purposes, go out together, all because one of them made a mistake with a giant lead.
A full course yellow in Toronto. Dario Franchitti is out corner one, same place he had trouble last year. Back live after this.
This is our river. Mud bugs, wet clothes. The in the great frontier. Well, the wildlife here. The only thing certain will be back next year.
This is our beer. coolest game on earth now offers the coolest credit card on earth. It's the official no-annual-fee NHL MasterCard issued by NBNA Canada. Call toll-free 1-877-HOCKEY-9 and apply for the credit card featuring your favorite NHL team logo. Score with exclusive cardholder benefits and save with a low introductory annual interest rate. A credit card made for hockey fans like you. The official no-annual-fee NHL MasterCard. Call toll-free 1-877-HOCKEY-9 now to apply for your official National Hockey League MasterCard.
Race fans, get ready for 3 days of fast-paced, high-stakes action on the water as the Ontario Place Offshore Challenge takes to the shores of Lake Ontario, September 11th to 13th. For more information, call 416-314-9835. Tickets available through Ticketmaster by calling 416-870-8000.
Back live in Toronto under a full course yellow with Bobby Unser, Greg Kramer, and Jan Vikas. I'm Brian Williams. There's Paul Tracy. The yellow car is Arne Meyer from Germany. The cool car is Paul Tracy, who has dropped down to 13th place. Tracy and his victim when his teammate, the race leader Dario Franchitti, spun in turn one. And Bobby, let's have a look at it as it happened on lap 80.
Here we come. Right there is Frank Keady. He hit the cement patch, got loose. No reason to be going that hard. Goes back, almost hits the wall with the wing. He does touch it. Now he tries to bust the rear car's tires loose. Do a Zanardi get around. Here's Michael Andretti coming up. He says, where do I go? No choice. Tries to fit it in between. Doesn't look like it'll fit.
Man,
but
he fits by a hair.
Now look at the guy that deserves the medal. But keeps going here is Jimmy Vasser. He really had no place to go.
There's Vasser. He went over the nose of the car.
With so both the front and the rear of his car.
And he's still in this race. Now, look, we've still got, what, 13, 12, 13 laps to go.
We got a lot of good racing left. Don't anybody leave and go to the ice box yet, because believe me, there's a lot of good racing left. This has been a good one all day, Brian.
Michael Andretti, followed by Alex Zanardi. Jimmy Vasser's third. They're saying one more lap as they go by. One more lap under yellow, and then we'll be racing.
And everybody watch
now. The Dustman car is Robbie Gordon. Robbie Gordon is not a factor in this race. He is well down.
But remember, we're going from yellow to a green. The passing has to happen now. Gordon's in a very, very kind of a bad place because these guys have to get by him quick.
Well, we get another shot. I'll set it for you. Andretti's the race leader. He's the first car. Gordon, Duskin car, is down in 14th place. He's a lap down, so he'll be a factor because they have to get by him. There is Vasser, who's second. There's Zanardi. There's Rahal. And there's Brian Herta in the shell car. So these drivers are going to have to move up.
Zanardi's ahead of Vasser right now.
Zanardi is ahead of Vasser. We had it the other way around. Zanardi with the white helmet. There's Vasser with the blue.
I was looking at the helmets when you said that, and I said, wait a minute here. All right.
On board with the race leader, Michael Andretti.
Pulling the shield here, down, getting ready for battle.
He stands here today to win his sixth Molson Indy Toronto, but the lights are out on the pace car. We'll be racing. On board with Zanardi. This could be a tremendous
you
race.
You can hear them clean their tires off. When that engine revs like that, that's the tires spinning. They're trying to get off all the rubber on the tires that's that extra rubber from the balls that are laying around the track that you see right there.
There's Franchitti in the pits, but the story is no longer Franchitti. It's the restart of this race. Michael Andretti is leading. Michael Andretti. Gordon is a lap down. The first red car is Alex Zanardi. The pace car, is into the pits. And down across the start-finish line with 12 laps to go comes Michael Andretti.
Michael really got a good jump on him. Here's where the problem is. Robbie Gordon should have pulled over out of the way.
He does. Zanardi goes by.
GS.
We could have a tremendous race to the finish with Zanardi all over Michael Andretti. Zanardi will have to make his move and move quickly. We're on board with Bobby Rahal. Rahal is running fourth. That's Jimmy Vasser to the right. Vasser is third as they go by Robbie Gordon, one of the back markers. Now on board still with Rahal. He's fourth. Vassar's third. And up ahead of Vasser is Zanardi, who is running second behind the race leader, Michael Andretti.
Look at the cars jerking around, a whole bunch getting loose. slippery this time of the day. This is the slipperiest and the hardest time of the race. But you got to admit, Robbie Gordon got out of their way, Brian. Did really good, as he should have, but he was a good sport about it.
11 laps to go. Will Alex Zanardi catch this man, Michael Andretti? There's Andretti, there's Zanardi. And the gap from Zanardi to his teammate, Jimmy Vasser. Zanardi trying to make it four wins in a row.
Oh, there's Bobby Rahal trying to get that. Oh, and he knocked his brakes up. Almost had another one right there. Rahal's really trying hard. You see these guys go in the turns, their front brakes aren't locking up, especially during the race. They're trying as hard as you can.
There's Bobby Rahal. The Kmart car with a yellow helmet is Christian Fittipaldi, who's down in 16th place and more than a lap down. So very confusing as you watch it right now, because not all cars are in the same laps. And a real test for some of these drivers, Bobby, is they'll have to go by the back markers to get up and go racing.
Well, you know, the guy that had the hardest right in that shot that we saw was Robbie Gordon, trying to get out of everybody's way and yet keep his car going, because if he makes one mistake, he could get two or three of those cars at one time.
If you're wondering about the two Canadians left in the race, Carpentier went out early. Greg Moore is running 10th, and Paul Tracy is running 13th. And Peter Dunn, our spotter, tells me, Peter, a bit of rain in the hairpin, I understand. All right, they say light rain at the hairpin. The rain was expected to hold off.
A little bit of light rain like that, unless the course is going to get wet, Wally Dalbeck won't call that it's raining. These guys who won't bother them, because the tires, the cars keep the track dry unless it gets heavy rain.
Bobby Rahal, as he chases Jimmy Vasser, Rahal's fourth, and Vasser, the red car in front of him, is third. They both trail Michael Andretti and Alex Zanardi. 9 laps to go in the 13th Molson Indy Toronto. It has been a dandy.
Oh, it has been a good one so far. It's one of the most exciting races I think I've ever seen in Toronto.
Rahal would love to be on the podium. He'd love to catch Vasser.
He's getting up to Vasser. He seems to be getting a little bit closer to him. You know, it really comes down to the very last who has the best tires.
All right, 9 laps to go, 8 laps to go. Jan Vikas, I mentioned the rain. Any word in the pits? I see rain on the camera lens here.
Well, it seems as though as soon as you mentioned rain, the teams went and got their rain tires. Christian Fittipaldi, Michael Andretti, they've all brought out their rain tires just in case. Now, from our perspective on pit road, it looks like we will make it to the end all dry, but these teams are taking no chances now having the rain tires on the wall. Let's get to Greg Kramer.
Beyond, I'm standing by with a very frustrated, unhappy driver, and Dario, it was a great run, but problems. What happened?
Yeah, it was a fantastic run right from the start. You know, the guys, you know, Don Halliday and the guys at Team Code Green did a fantastic job with the setup of the car, and I was cruising towards the end. But from about, I don't know, the 10th lap onward or something, the brake pedal started to give me problems. We've had a problem with it all weekend. We thought we cured it, but the pedal goes long on occasions. Other times you have good pressure there, so it's very inconsistent. It caught me out just going into turn one. I went for the brake. I pressed the brake down at the same time. There was so much travel, I caught the throttle pedal, and round she went.
Obviously, you ended up stalling the engine, and you were just parked there. Did anybody get into you hard, or did everybody avoid you?
The only person to get into me was Paul. Paul came pretty close. Paul hit the side of my car and broke the radiator, so the car was broken after that. But, you know, I kept it running when it spun. I just couldn't get it into reverse, the problem with that. But, you know, I'm just so frustrated for my guys. I thought we had that easily today as a crew. But something always seems to crop up, you know. It's
Dario, you showed him today nonetheless. Gentlemen.
Thank you, Greg. Bobby, some thoughts?
Oh, I know how bad he feels. You know, everybody that's a race driver makes a mistake like that occasionally. And no matter what, he had too much of a lead. He shouldn't have made that big a mistake, but that's all right. He's a young man. Learning time.
Now, speaking of learning, you've got the veteran, Michael Andretti, and the young charging Italian, Alessandro Zanardi. And Zanardi has really moved up on Andretti with 6 laps to go.
That's a bad place to have Zanardi. Michael is sitting there thinking, why does it have to be Zanardi? Why couldn't it be somebody else? So I don't know if he's going to get him. Look at Zanardi pull up at that turn. I mean, we know that Zanardi is a stubborn Italian. He's not going to give Mark Michael any slack whatsoever. If there's a way, it's going to happen.
Well, I can hear the tifosi, the great Italian racing fans, cheering right now for the young man from Bologna. Word is he'll go to Formula One. See, Michael now pulling away a bit as they go up beside the Gardiner Expressway. As he slows for the right hand, Zanardi comes right back up on him. Ford Cosworth power for Michael Andretti, a Honda engine. Honda very efficient on fuel for Alex Zanardi. How do they compare power-wise?
They're about the same. Everything, the Toyota is a little bit behind this year, but the other engines, the Mercedes and the Honda and the Ford, they're all just about the same right now. They all turn about the same RPM. Everybody says Honda's a little better on fuel. And right now, I think that they're all the engines are about the same. It shows you how competitive it is, too. If they all do about the same fuel, same revs, and the same power, hey, that shows you competition's working the way it's supposed to.
Oh, that's Paul Tracy. Paul Tracy in turn one. Paul Tracy was running in 10th place. There's Al Unser Jr., followed by Michelle Jourdain and Alex Fernandez.
It looks like his engine's dead there, otherwise he'd be spinning around and going. Tracy's saying, my gosh, I had a pretty good day all day, now it's turning the heck on me.
Five laps to go. Adrian Fernandez is running ninth. Paul Tracy was running ninth, or was running 10th. Let's see what happens. This is Fernandez to Cotti. There's Tracy trying to pass.
Paul made a gamble on it. He went in there.
Whose fault?
He shouldn't have gambled that much.
Whose fault, buddy?
Yeah, that one is really a racing accident. That really wasn't either one of them's fault. Adrian was committed going in. If I was Paul, I'd have tried that pass right there.
Here's the story with four laps to go. Michael Andretti, look at this. Zanardi is all over Michael Andretti as they go through turn three and up the old third base side of Exhibition Stadium.
Remember what I said. Michael's thinking, why, oh Lord, does it have to be Zanardi behind me?
Paul Tracy pulls over and lets the first and second place cars go through. Michael Andretti's the race leader. Zanardi's trying to pass him. Vasser is third. Ray Hall fourth. Ryan Hurd is fifth. The top Canadian, Greg Moore, is running in 11th place.
It's very rare that you see somebody that has a drive to win as much as that Alex Zanardi. But Michael is fast today. He's fast every time we come to Toronto. We knew that he should be a factor if he keeps running all day, and he is a factor.
Three laps to go.
And our third place runner, Jimmy Vasser, is starting to experience shifting problems. So Jimmy Vasser is called in, says, hey, there's something wrong with the shifting of this car. He may not be able to hold on to third spot.
Vasser goes by Michael Andretti. Zanardi goes by Michael Andretti.
See what I mean? Michael says, oh, Lord, why Zanardi? And he did it again. Oh, he has done this so many times. I don't believe in my lifetime I've ever seen anybody that consistently pulled that rabbit out of the hat like this Zanardi does.
What a great move by Alex Zanardi. Jan was talking about Vasser, and just as we come back, his teammate Zanardi goes by Michael Andretti. That could be the move of the day. Canaan had a great pass earlier on Paul Tracy, but late in the race,
this one outdid that, I dare guarantee you.
And now Zanardi just pulling away, trying to make it four wins in a row.
We told everybody a little while ago this race wasn't over yet. Look at this, rerun of it. Zanardi faked him over, got in there, and he really got all four wheels there. So he didn't gouge, he didn't push, he didn't chop. He really did it. Look at over to the left. There's Zanardi. Before he got Michael locked out, before Michael even knew what happened. Good pass. One of the best passes I've ever seen right there. Both of them going in there with their tires locked up, smoke coming off of them.
Well, two laps to go, and Alex Zanardi from Bologna, Italy, has driven a magnificent race here this afternoon. He's won at Detroit, Portland, and Cleveland. Toronto would make him only the second driver to win four in a row. Al Unser Jr. has done it three times. He's expected to leave IndyCar racing and head to Frank Williams in Formula One for 1999. One lap to go. Final lap for Alex Zanardi.
I'm surprised that Zanardi didn't wait till the last lap to do that pass.
If he's on the podium here, and barring a disaster, he will be, it'll be 15 times in the last 18 races. He's been second here in Toronto the last 2 years. Final time through turn three for Alex Zanardi from Bologna, Italy. There's Vasser, his teammate, who's running third, followed by Bobby Rahal, who's fourth. So it'll be a big afternoon for Chip Ganassi.
Rahal done good today, too. Bobby Rahal had a good race. Michael's hoping, he's praying, but unless something happens, this is going to be it.
This is it indeed. Alex Zanardi wins in Toronto. Four wins in a row. Detroit, Portland, Cleveland, and now Toronto, joining Al Unser Jr. as the only kart drivers to win four in a row. Chip Ganassi in the white shirt, extremely happy. As his cars are first and third, Zanardi wins, followed by, look at him, he's got such,
did you ever see
so much
get
personality.
So excited? I mean,
this is great.
You've got to admire that guy. You know, if he does go to Formula One, we're going to miss him so much. He's literally becoming a legend in this part of the world. One heck of a good race driver. Good sport, and just generally a nice person.
That's his teammate, Jimmy Vasser, alongside. There's Bobby Rahal's car. Rahal finishes fourth. Zanardi wins. Michael Andretti second. Vasser third. Rahal fourth. Brian Herta fifth. Scott Pruitt sixth. The top Canadian, Greg Moore, will finish 11th. Paul Tracy will finish 14th.
In all my years of racing, Brian, I never seen any driver unhook his seat belt while he's still going fast and jump out of the car to tell everybody how happy he is and how to talk to his fans, let them know, yahoo, I did another one. Fabulous. Look at that guy. Look at him. I admire that guy. Look at him. Look at him.
It's great television. It is great theater.
I know it.
It is great theater.
Nobody leaves their television set when that guy's around.
Interesting story. His sister, as a teenager, was killed in a car accident. His dad was always concerned about racing and speed, so Alex Zanardi said, well, he'll switch from motorcycles to go-karts because they're a lot safer. He said, I wanted to do that for my father after my sister was killed. He's an amazing man when you talk to him. I listened to him and spoke with him this morning. He was talking about this course, said it's one of the shorter courses they race on, but the yellow flags make for a long afternoon, and it's been a fairly long afternoon here today as Zanardi comes in.
Just think what he's been through all day,
right? All right.
There's going to do donuts again. Look at that. Now, Frank Keating could have done this or would have done it properly. He wouldn't have been sitting there where everybody would have hit him.
I tell you what, the people at Tim Hortons can't do it any better than this. This capacity crowd is going crazy. Well, I said it was great theater. Bobby Unser jumping up and down. The people are enjoying it. Alex Zanardi has put a show on here today in Toronto.
Who wouldn't go to a race like this?
We'll take a break and we'll come back and talk with a man from Bologna, Italy.
All across Canada, we're making it easier to get out on the road during Canada-wide clearance. Right now, get outstanding lease offers or 1.9% financing on virtually every vehicle, including the car more Canadians depend on, the Chevrolet Cavalier. And on the Chevrolet Malibu, you'll get a lot more than you expect. Or drive home in the sophisticated midsize Oldsmobile Intrigue. The huge selection makes this a great time to buy or lease. So hit the road to your Chevrolet Oldsmobile dealer for Canada-wide clearance.
In other countries, differences of opinion may cause persecution, imprisonment, or even war.
Brake problems?
You should have heard the sound. I'm thinking, uh-oh.
Right now, get 50% off Speedy's brake pads and shoes, backed by our famous guarantee.
Now that's treating me like a somebody.
It's a constant battle.
technology striving for the perfect automobile finish, nature dead set on destroying it. But Turtle Wax fights back with an army of advanced auto care for quick, easy shine in minutes. Express Shine to condition tires, dash, and leather. Formula 2001 Super Protectant for a brilliant finish. Emerald Series Car Wax. Even weathered veterans come out shining with Turtle Wax at the front.
The Beaver, a diligent handyman, spends hours searching for home renovation materials. Unfortunately, though, he often forgets what he's looking for. A ClearNet PCS phone and its affordable rate plans would enable him to call home whenever he needs a reminder. But like many a handyman, he doesn't take criticism well.
No contract to sign and very affordable to use. Isn't it time you had a ClearNet PCS phone?
Yeah, I've always said time is money, and money is time.
Speedy saves you both. Right now, get 50% off brake pads and shoes, backed by Speedy's famous guarantee.
Because I am a somebody. Back me up here, guy. Come on.
Well, a great race.
Back at the Molson Indy, Alex Zanardi has made it to pit road. You took a few stops along the way for some donuts, but I have to ask you, you rounded the corner, you saw Dario Franchitti. You had a choice of going left or right. It looked to you as though going right was the key.
Well, I didn't make the decision. Chip was really fast today, and he told me to go right. I just believed him, and he was just going in one direction with your eyes closed, but it worked. I mean, I have to thank Chip because he made the call, and it really helped this time.
Now, tell me about then trying to move past Michael Andretti. A big, bold move for you. Was that a risk to take? Did he know you were coming?
I'm sure he knew. Otherwise, he would have taken the normal line. I guess he drove a protected line going into the turn, and then as soon as he saw that I braked too, he just moved over to get a better run into the corner. And at that point, when I saw the space, I just took my foot off the brake pedal, let the car roll in, and that was it.
After the first pit stop, when you were behind Jimmy, the car was slipping and sliding. It looked like you were struggling. Were you concerned at that point if you'd be able to win this thing?
The main problem I had was with the brakes. I had no bite at the front, and I was locking the rear all the time. And on top of everything, the pedal was going down. So I thought, you know, fourth place is good enough. But then the occasion came by and made me hungry again.
Is this the last time we're going to see you in Toronto?
It's a good question. I don't know. No, definitely not the last time in Canada.
All right. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, I'm standing by with Michael Andretti, and Michael, so close to win number six here. Take us through what happened at the end.
Pretty simple. I just ran out of tires. You know, I did everything I can, but my rear tires just weren't surviving, and I was basically a sitting duck for him, and, you know, he had a good run on me going into turn two, and I tried to pinch as close as I could to the wall, but I didn't want to hit, you know, I didn't want to get us in an accident, so I gave him just enough room, and he took advantage of it.
Notice the first thing you did when you got out of the car was went and looked at Alex's tires. Obviously, that's a concern.
Well, yeah. I mean, you know, I think that's what won the race.
And the question that we have to ask you as well is when Dario got his car crossed up, I mean, that was so close. How close was it for you to sneak through there?
I hit him. You know, it was that close. I hit him with my right rear. I was worried that maybe it gave me a flat tire or something because I have no idea how I made it through there. I was just very lucky.
All right, Michael, well, we wish you the best of luck as the year unfolds. Let's check in with Jan.
Well, Jimmy Vasser came in third today, and Jimmy, when you came down into turn number one, we just talked to Alex. He said Chip told him to go to the right, yet you went to the left and caught the front end there of Franchitti.
Yeah, I was told it was in turn three, but I saw the yellows, and I was right behind Mike, and I just couldn't see Franchitti in the road, and Mike was one car closer to him than me, and, you know, I just couldn't guide it. I couldn't react quick enough. I was locked up on the concrete. There's no grip, and... You know, I caught him on the one side, and I think it bent my right rear a bit because I had a vibration and a funky car after that. But, you know, Zanardi's amazing. It's good to have two target cars on the podium.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Okay.
Well, Bobby Unser, if you were listening to what Alex Zanardi said, great question. Jan Bika said, is this your last race in Toronto? He says, not my last race in Canada. There, of course, is a Formula One race in Canada. I think he's all but gone to Frank Williams. You made an interesting comment to me during that last commercial as far as this being one of the best races you've seen.
I think that we may have seen the best race in modern times. I really do. I think We saw a tremendous athlete, a tremendous race driver in Alex Zanardi. I think we saw good racing today by a lot of race drivers, including Michael and just a lot of guys, but that's all right. It never quit on us all day. It just got better, better, better. And every time we thought it was going to settle down and be normal, it got more unnormal. And so, as far as I'm concerned, we may have seen the best race race in modern times.
You know, the Formula One people, and some of them tend to be a bit snobbish, will often put down kart. Roger Penske once said to me, kart has personality, it's competitive. We saw that. We saw the great theater today by Alex Zanardi. Should he go to Formula One, boy, he'll be a fresh breath of air over there.
Oh, I know it. We're going to miss him so bad. I don't care if he comes from Italy or where he comes from. Guy's a good race driver. We needed him over here, and I'm like you. I think we're going to lose him.
Well,
but
I tell
that's
you,
all right. Somebody else, I guess, will replace him down the road.
Well, the phrase today is Forza Italia. The tifosi, the great Italian fans, will be celebrating a win here by Zanardi. You've got to get to the airport to get back to Albuquerque. We're going to say goodbye. Quick final thought on the afternoon. Paul Tracy, you were tough on Tracy at the top of the show. The way he raced today, what do you think?
He did good. He just did good all day, and I think that if Paul would stay like that, hey, we know that you've got some good Canadians up here in race drivers. Greg Moore, same way. Don't worry about Zanardi. Just do your own life, because he's too good not to do that. Tracy will always be good if he just do that. So I think, again, glad I came. I'm really glad I saw this race. I know I acted more like a race fan watching it than I did an announcer, but I really enjoyed it.
Well, I had to tie him to the seat on two or three occasions. Have a safe trip back to New Mexico. We'll see you Labor Day weekend for the Molson Indy Vancouver. Lots more to come. You know what that is? That is an Zanardi signature.
I know it.
The people at Tim Hortons would be proud of that one.
It's Canada-wide clearance time, featuring 1.9% financing and excellent leases on a huge selection of most 98 models, like the GMC Sierra, strength and style, 365 days a year, and the more than a minivan, GMC Safari, the GMC Jimny with capability and comfort, and the Pontiac Transport, the minivan that's built for drivers. Hurry in for Canada-wide clearance at your Pontiac Buick GMC dealers.
Sometimes the temptation can be too much. But if you've decided to quit smoking, Nicorette nicotine chewing pieces help take away the cravings for a cigarette. And that may be the edge you need. Nicorette, because you're bound to be tempted.
Hey, here's big news. Know how you love the great flavor of extra sugar-free gum? Now the flavor lasts longer than ever. So you can enjoy even more of life's little extras, like extra mileage, extra innings, even extra credit. And the flavor will last right through. In fact, Extra's flavor now lasts so long, it may even attract some extra attention. So take any extra steps you need to try new Extra. Why? Now the flavor lasts longer than ever. The taste never quits.
Buddy, what are you doing? Hey, this is all my expensive sporting equipment.
I told you.
Honey, I promise. More time with you, less time with sports.
You promise?
Of course I do. I love you. Oh! My car.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Call 1-888-SPEEDY8 for a speedy near you.
I am stuck on Band-Aid brand, cause Band-Aid stuck on me.
New Band-Aid brand antibiotic bandages from Johnson & Johnson, with antibiotic right on the pad for infection protection.
Cause Band-Aid helps heal me.
Tonight, Mr. Reach conquers the evil black man. With new Reach Tooth and Gum Care, get the only brush with feather-tipped bristles proven to clean gum-lined plaque best.
And don't just brush, reach.
Set for the official presentations. Once again, the popular morning man from CFRB Radio here in Toronto, Ted Wallish. And Ted, it's all yours.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon and welcome to the conclusion of this, the 13th annual Molson Indy in Toronto, and you don't get races much better than this one. We're going to give you an opportunity to meet the top three finishers and the team owner in just a moment. Right now, I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce you to the Minister of Consumer and Corporate Affairs for the Province of Ontario, the Honorable David Tabucci.
Well, hi, Ted. Thanks very much. I just want to thank everyone for coming out today on behalf of Premier Harris and the Province of Ontario supporting this great event. I'd like to thank Molson's for the great sponsorship and the drivers for putting on a great show. Just want everyone to drive safely home, and we had all greater time, I think. Thanks, Ted.
Thank you very much, Mr. DiBucci. Ladies and gentlemen, your third place finisher, driving for Target Ganassi, number 12, Jimmy Vasser. This was one exciting race from your perspective. The last half dozen to a dozen laps were as tight as they get. What are your feelings?
Oh, it was a great race. It's the first time in a long time I've been able to dice around with Zanardi. It doesn't seem like we're always on the track at the same time at the same place. But, the incident with Dario Franchitti was pretty detrimental to us. But I'm still real happy to have two Target cars on the podium and to get good points moving into second in the championship. The only problem is I keep slipping behind Zanardi with another Zanardi victory. So, hopefully we can start getting some victories and catching up.
Who buys dinner, you or Alex?
Well, I think he's buying tonight.
Jimmy Vasser, congratulations. To present the trophy, Toronto Maple Leaf superstar, Ty Domi. The next gentleman comes to us hoping for a sixth straight, or a sixth victory at least here in Toronto. He came so close. In second place, driving for Newman Haas, Michael Andretti. Congratulations, Michael, on a great race. Came so close to making it a half dozen here in Toronto.
Yeah, close, but we didn't do it. It was a shame. our car was halfway decent, but in the end of each run, I was just struggling a little bit to keep my rear tires under me, Alex was able to take advantage of that.
Well, congratulations. It's always good to see you here in Toronto. You've become a big part of the summer of Toronto. Both you and your dad, and we congratulate you on your second place finish. To present the trophy, ladies and gentlemen, he needs no introduction, but I promised I'd give him one. Mr. Hockey, Don Cherry. Now to introduce you to the man responsible for two of the young gentlemen who are on the podium with us this evening. From Target Racing, please welcome the owner, Chip Ganassi. Congratulations to you. You're probably spending more time on the podium this year than you are in your office.
I'll tell you, Ted, it's, we love to come up to Toronto here. Today was, that Barry Green and the Cool team, they had a great day going there, and my heart goes out to them. And after that, I turned around, I saw Michael in front of us, and our team had some success with him here in 94, and he's a tough competitor, I'll tell you. And I don't know what could go any better this season, but every week we seem to have some excitement. And if you can beat Michael heads up at this place, you got a great team, I think, and a great driver. So I couldn't be happier. I love being here in Toronto, and they got great race fans here. Thanks, everybody.
What do you think of the Donut King?
Well, I was looking at the donuts on the front straightaway there, and I was just looking at the rear wing getting close to the wall, but he's in control. Don't worry.
Thank you, Chip Ganassi. Congratulations to you. Don Barnett from Molson will present you with the trophy for the winner. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's the fourth consecutive victory for this year's winner of the 1998 Molson Indy. Please welcome the incredible Alex Zanardi. Come say a few words to us. Como está?
Molto bene.
Yeah, I would think so. Four in a row for you. It's quite an amazing accomplishment. What are you feeling right now?
Well, I obviously feel really happy. Today it came in a very unexpected way. At one point in the race, I was running fourth and I had no brakes left. And I had a very good battle with my teammate, Jimmy Vasser. And I thought that was going to be it, you know. And then the last yellow really brought the car underneath me again, because the brakes lost some temperature and start to get good again. And on top of everything, Michael had, I believe, some problems with the tire. I'm not really sure, but I can't speak on his behalf. But his performance dropped out a little bit, and we went at the end of the straight. He protected his line like everybody in this world would do, and then I had to brake. At the last moment, he lost the car probably a little bit, so I saw the gap and I said, I'm gonna go for it, you know, and took my foot off the brake pedal, let the car roll in, and it worked.
It did work. Lots of fans here for you. I don't know if you've got any room in your mantle at home, but we want to present you with this trophy to be the victor of the 1998 Molson Indy from John Barnett and Molson Breweries. Alex Zanardi, ladies and gentlemen.
Lots more to come. We'll return to Toronto right after this.
In other countries, differences of opinion may cause persecution, imprisonment, or even war.
Canada's Auto Parts Store, Canadian Tire offers you even more. Like our Loan a Tool program. If you need an auto tool, just come to our auto parts counter, choose from a selection of specialized tools, and we'll loan you one at no charge. And there's more. You can also bring your brake drums and rotors to any Canadian Tire Auto Parts counter, and one of our staff will expertly machine them for you. It's convenient, and you know the job will be done right. Canadian Tire, Canada's Auto Parts Store.
Drive into Travelodge locations across North America, where you can earn Travelodge miles on each day. Redeem Travelodge miles for guest rewards like free nights, airline miles, watches, cameras, and more. Plus, earn 750 Travelodge miles between June 1st and September 18th to get an automatic bonus gift of 4 free tickets to this summer's cool movie, Small Soldiers. So call 1-800-578-7878 now and rack up Travelodge miles for great rewards.
For all those times you wished you had a camera, get the only one-time use camera loaded with Kodak Max film.
Hold it?
Because no matter how difficult your subject is, gotcha. You blinked. You'll get better pictures more often.
One more. Smile! Never mind! I think I got it!
Max one-time use cameras from Kodak.
The newly acquired and newly launched Hilfiger Athletics Airship with Mike Fitzpatrick and Bart Van Beest. The captain's at the control this afternoon. It will travel extensively over the next year, helping televise special and sporting events throughout North America. Alex Zanardi makes it 4 in a row. The only other driver to do that, and he's done it 3 times, is Al Unser Jr. Michael Andretti denied a 6th victory here in Toronto. Paul Tracy finishes 14th. The top Canadian, though, is Greg Moore, 11. Carpentier did not finish the race, with Moore finishing 11th today, and Jimmy Vasser on the podium with his teammate Alex Zanardi. Vasser has moved into second place in the driver's standings. You look at the order of finish for the entire 28-car field. So look at this big, big lead for Alex Zanardi over his teammate Jimmy Vasser. Moore drops to third. Adrian Fernandez, who won here 2 years ago. Michael Andretti, a 5-time winner here. Dario Franchitti, who had the mistake, a very costly mistake, with just a few laps to go. He spins into turn one, and it was all over this afternoon for Franchitti. Alex Zanardi, 4 wins in a row as he wins here in Toronto today. And I think at the time I said he is simply great theater. Good for racing. The fans love him.
My new Dave's Honey Brown is now at your beer store. Recently, a number of Honey Brown beers have been introduced in Canada, but they're clearly priced at a premium. Well, I've done something about that. Now beer drinkers can enjoy Dave's Honey Brown Lager and save up to $4 on a 12-pack. I didn't compromise on the ingredients, but what I did do was decide not to pack it in a special bottle, which is one of the reasons it's such a great value. My new Dave's Honey Brown. Ordinary bottle, extraordinary beer.
Across Canada, we're making it easier to get out on the road during Canada-wide clearance. Get outstanding lease offers or 1.9% financing on virtually every vehicle, including the Chevrolet Venture. It'll have your family saying, let's go. Get into Chevy Astro with V6 power and room for eight. Or drive the security of Chevy Blazer. Or get a dependable and long-lasting Chevy pickup. The huge selection makes this a great time to buy or lease. So hit the road to your Chevrolet Oldsmobile dealer for Canada-wide clearance.
The coolest game on earth now offers the coolest credit card on earth. It's the official no-annual-fee NHL MasterCard issued by NBNA Canada. Call toll-free 1-877-HOCKEY-9 and apply for the credit card featuring your favorite NHL team logo. Score with exclusive cardholder benefits and save with a low introductory annual interest rate. A credit card made for hockey fans like you. The official no-annual-fee NHL MasterCard. Call toll-free 1-877-HOCKEY-9 now to apply for your official National Hockey League MasterCard.
Another Nokia discovery. Hands do not have sharp edges. So, neither do our phones. At Nokia, we design them with soft, round corners to better fit the human hand. Not to mention the human pocket or purse. Inspired technology with a human touch. Nokia. Connecting people.
The Molson Indy, live on CBC. Brought to you by Export Ale, title sponsor of the Molson Indy. By Chevrolet. Chevrolet, tried, tested, and true. And by MBNA Canada, a proud sponsor of the Molson Indy.
Just an excellent and entertaining race here this afternoon. Zanardi makes it four in a row. John Cerruti was with us here in the booth tonight and or this afternoon. He'll join me next Friday night at Fenway Park in Boston as we will bring you the Toronto Blue Jays and the Boston Red Sox. Alex Zanardi, the story. The word we have is that Zanardi will be going to Formula One with Frank Williams. You perhaps heard the interview where he said, I'm not sure I'll be back in Toronto, but I will definitely be back in Canada. Of course, the Formula One circuit races in Canada in Montreal. We talked about Greg Moore. Bobby Unser is not so sure about it today. He was very sure yesterday that Unser would be joining, or I should say that Moore would be joining Al Unser Jr. with Roger Penske next year. Now apparently they're not so sure of that, but the word tonight is that Alex Zanardi is a go to Formula One and Frank Williams. I mentioned the Major League Baseball. Don't forget next Friday night at 7 Eastern, John Cerruti will join me, the first of three games this weekend from Fenway. Saturday afternoon at 2:30 Eastern, the Pacific Alliance Gymnastics.